Mississippi. Oklahoma State. Eli Manning is the man for Ole Miss. All-American. Rashawn Woods leads the Cowboys. All-American. Behind them, a terrific supporting cast by air or by ground. It's pure offensive firepower. The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic is next. A sellout crowd of over 70,000 jam-packed into the Cotton Bowl. Two schools whose programs are on the rise collide for the first time. We welcome you to Dallas for the 68th annual SBC Cotton Bowl, where 21st-ranked Oklahoma State takes on number 16, the Ole Miss Rebels. And a happy new year to you and yours alongside Bill Moss and Tim Green. I'm Tom Brenneman. So glad to have you with us. And what a thrilling game we could have in store for you today. The Ole Miss Rebels, Tim, have not been to the Cotton Bowl since 1962. And a big reason they're here this season, the play of their All-American quarterback, Eli Manning.
But believe it or not, Tommy, this offense has got more than Eli Manning. They've got a great run game against a very powerful offensive line. It gives them balance, and then the focus goes on Eli Manning. He is a phenomenal player. He's got the strong arm, the quick release, all the physical skills, but the thing that makes him most special is what's inside his helmet. He knows this offense so well. Heck, it's the same offense his brother Peyton ran at Tennessee. He's been studying it for 9 years. He makes brilliant adjustments. Now, as far as their defense goes, it's a no-name defense, but keep your eye on this name right here, Jesse Mitchell, senior defensive lineman. He is the heart and soul of Ole Miss's D.
Well, that Ole Miss defense faces a tall order here today, Bill Moss, in facing this Oklahoma State Cowboy team, one of the best offensive teams in all of college football.
Gentlemen, in the words of Jimmy Johnson, how about them Cowboys? Oklahoma State fans are certainly excited about what they've done and what they've accomplished in the last 3 years under Les Miles. This offense is explosive. Rashawn Woods, how about him, the All-American wide receiver? This guy can put up some big numbers. He's big, he's powerful, he finds a way to get open. But the way this offense works, it starts on the ground. It starts with Tatum Bell. He starts pounding the line of scrimmage. He has 7 touchdowns. He also has over 1,200 yards rushing. The guy who orchestrates it all is the quarterback, Josh Fields. And if you think back in Cowboy history about a three-headed monster, it certainly takes you to 1988 when you had Hartley Dykes, Barry Sanders, and the quarterback, who is now the offensive coordinator, Mike Gundy.
Some would say that was the heyday of Oklahoma State football. Les Miles bringing the Cowboys back to national prominence. The kickoff in the SBC Cotton Bowl is coming up next. The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox, brought to you by SBC, going beyond the call. By WebMD, redefining modern medicine. By Acura, experience the performance today at your local Acura dealer. And by the greatest sports miracle in history, Miracle, coming to theaters February 6th, rated PG. Out of the Big 12 Conference, we welcome the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Back the clock, September the 20th, Rashawn Woods had a record 7 touchdown receptions. 2 weeks later, Oklahoma State faced Kansas State and had their biggest win of the season. The following week, Tatum Bell broke for a 95-yard touchdown run against Texas Tech, all part of an in-season 7-game win streak for the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And now set to take the field, playing in the Cotton Bowl for the first time in 41 years out of the Southeastern Conference, the Ole Miss Rebels. Oh.
Ole Miss had a six-game winning streak that started October the 4th at the Swamp. Bashawn Pearson's touchdown late in the fourth quarter, the difference over the Gators. They capped their winning streak November 8th in Auburn. In the final minute, they stopped the Tigers on four goal plays. Let's send it downstairs to our public address announcer, Bill Melton.
And commander of U.S. Central Command in Operation Enduring Freedom and Operation Iraqi Freedom, General Tommy Franks.
Gentlemen, be here today. General Franks.
Here with you. Thank you very much.
Captains, the coin has each team's logo on each side. When the general flips it, the side that comes up, that's won the toss. OSU's won the toss. OSU won the toss. Have deferred to the second half. You want the football, which way will you defend? Swing around here, Ole Miss here. Gentlemen, let's have a great ball game.
While we have a moment, we'd like to welcome in our fourth member of the broadcast team of the Cotton Bowl again this season. Say hello to Brian Baldinger, the former Dallas Cowboy.
Thanks, Tom. I'm down here with the head coach of the Ole Miss Rebels, David Cutcliffe. And David, this is your fifth bowl game since you've been here as the head coach. But how important is it for this Cotton Bowl? This is a chance for 10 wins here for the first time in a long time with the Rebels.
Well, it's the first time in 32 years, so it's obviously big to all of us. Great job of getting here, and now we got to finish the job.
Coach, you had Peyton Manning for 4 years at Tennessee, all five years with Eli Manning. How important has Eli been to this program and to you as a coach?
Well, Eli's a great person, first of all. It's been a pleasure to coach him. He displays work ethic like nobody else. It's been fun. We'll hopefully finish it off strong today with him.
All right, good luck today, Coach. Take care. Tom, back up to you.
Brian, thank you very much. Great to have Brian Baldinger with us again this season. What a turnout, what a crowd, and what a day. 70 degrees. Les Miles, a 50-year-old native of Elyria, Ohio, played collegiately at the University of Michigan in his third year at Oklahoma State, and what a turnaround. Four wins his first year, going for his 10th win this season here today.
Tom, Oklahoma State won the coin toss and deferred to the second half. Quite a bold move, you know, and an excitement amongst the team. They come here and they know this game is going to be about field position, and I think they want to get their defense out there and set the tone early.
I think it makes a statement, Bill. It says, bring Eli Manning on.
Cole Farden set to kick it off, and back deep for Ole Miss, Chris Collins and Brian Brown.
Pretty gutsy, if you ask me, when you have the 77th ranked defense in the NCAA to send them out there.
And the 68th SBC Cotton Bowl underway. And that one booted a mile. So right out of the gate, we'll get a look at the fifth-year senior quarterback, Eli Manning. He holds 45 Ole Miss records. 27 of those used to belong to his daddy, Archie Manning, a former Ole Miss quarterback great. His brother, Cooper, was a wide receiver at Ole Miss, and you know all about Peyton Manning.
And as many impressive physical attributes as this guy has, wouldn't you guys say the most impressive thing about him is his personality, his humility, his focus, and his composure?
Let's just say it runs in the family.
Get away from me.
The play fake, Manning to throw across the middle and dropped by Mike Espy, the generally sure-handed sophomore, unable to pull it in there. Let's take a look at Ole Miss offensively. Doug Buckles, a first-team All-SEC performer during the season. Tremaine Turner, one of three running backs that you'd see a great deal of playing time today, and Chris Collins has been their go-to guy for the last 4 years. dropped at the line of scrimmage. Tripped up by Vernon Grant. Ole Miss has surrendered a pile of big plays on defense this season. So too has Oklahoma State. Greg Richmond, 12 and a half sacks during the season. Majid McGee, along with Paul Duren, the leading tackler for the Cowboys. And in the secondary, Darren Williams, the first-team All-Big 12 performer.
OSU showing the blitz. They want to blitz and get pressure on Eli Manning.
And then Eli Manning's checking out of it, Tom.
Good protection, wide open. And dropped by Espy. That ball thrown a bit behind him. So two drops early on. Ole Miss.
You know, in the college game, it is such an emotional game, and to come out and to defer on the coin toss and get a break like that with your defense on the two drop balls, that should have been caught.
I like the decision to go to Espy because he dropped the first one. It's an easy one. He's a big part of the offense, but now I think you've got to go somewhere else.
Gabe Lindsey averages 15 yards per return. He ran one back 55 yards for a touchdown against Wyoming. And he'll have a chance to return this one from the 33. Got a block. Turns a corner. And he's now to the 47.
Great field position.
Yard return by Lindsey, and let's meet the Oklahoma State offense led by the junior quarterback, a native of Stillwater, Oklahoma, Josh Fields, in what could be his final game as quarterback of the Cowboys. A very highly rated, highly thought of baseball prospect, and is eligible for the June amateur draft in 2004.
Big time third baseman for the Oklahoma State Cowboys baseball team.
Fire out to Woods. A little bit of room and a pickup of eight. Rashawn Woods, a first-team All-Big 12 performer. Fourth all-time in NCAA history with 282 receptions. Sam Mays, big. 6'3", 350 out of Austintown, Ohio, leads him up front. And in the backfield, Tatum Bell, a fabulous runner. Sean Willis, his lead blocker. And Rashawn Woods, we will call his name a great deal here today. This is Tatum Bell, and he has picked up the first down. Close to the 40-yard line, tripped up by Charlie Anderson. Anderson, five sacks, one of three seniors along the defensive front line, including Jesse Mitchell. Timmy talked about him earlier. In a 4-2-5, Spence and Wade, the linebackers, and in the secondary, Kelvin Robinson, the strong safety. Travis Johnson had that interception return for a touchdown against LSU on the very first play of the game. Fields dropped at the 44. Josh Cooper, who had 3.5 sacks during the season, an early one here in the Cotton Bowl.
Well, Mississippi is taking a chance on the outside. They're covering Rashawn Woods in man-to-man coverage. You see Travis right here. He's got that man-to-man coverage, but Josh Fields doesn't have the time to find him.
Because they brought an extra guy, and that's what happens when you bring an extra guy out of the secondary. You're going to leave a guy man-to-man. That time it was Travis Johnson outside, and the rush got there.
Bell will pick up about half of that down to the 38-yard line. Why a 4-2-5 defense?
Well, you know, the reason is because in college, you really don't have the time to develop all the run game. And with these two offenses in particular, all the guys up front just keep rotating. The offensive linemen all through the year have rotated.
And this guy, Travis Blanchard, 13, he's what they call the whip safety. He's really the key to that 4-2-5. He's the five. He's the fifth defensive back who they ask to blitz and play like a linebacker. Here he is right there.
Third and seven.
Open it up!
Fields in trouble and down again. Anderson, Mitchell, and company.
That Ole Miss blitz is certainly working.
And that's the problem when you have the change of lines. When you don't have the continuity in your offensive lines, disguises and different kinds of blitz formations cause confusion. So the college game, Tom, has become more of a passing type game. And that's why you get a guy out there, the whip safety, and he's the kind of a guy that is a weak side linebacker slash extra safety.
Yes, we will let it drop, and it's into the end zone. They'll bring it out to the 20. A good, solid defensive stop early on by Ole Miss. Oklahoma State at great field position. No score from Dallas. We'll be back. Well, 11-18 to play in the opening quarter. Eli Manning will lead the Ole Miss offense onto the field for the second time. He has had an amazing career at his daddy's and his mama's alma mater. Coming out to about the 24-yard line, Tremaine Turner. Some of the accomplishments for Eli Manning. The list goes on and on. Second team All-American. The SEC's Offensive Player of the Year. The Johnny Unitas Golden Arm Award. The Maxwell Award. Finished third in the Heisman balloting.
45 school records. And a lot of them were records that his dad had held. And when we asked him about breaking his dad's records, he said, well, I didn't think my dad's records were all that impressive.
He said, who cares about attempts? You can have all the attempts you want.
Yeah, one thing he said his dad Archie had, though, was better feet. He was a better running quarterback.
Again, Turner, and wrapped up immediately. Afajit McGee, the sophomore out of Tyler, Texas. There you see some of the numbers. Of course, back in Archie's day, they didn't throw nearly as much as they do today. Another big difference, of course, back when Archie Manning came into college football, freshmen were ineligible to play across the board in any sport.
Hence the 68-70 right under his name.
Third and four.
Nice play. Nice break on the ball. Big time play by the linebacker, Paul Duren. They were in two deep with a man underneath, and they manned everybody up. They had the two safeties high. Duren had the slot receiver, Collins, their number one go-to guy on third downs. What a great break on the ball.
When you're Eli Manning and you see this mismatch right there, an inside linebacker on your top receiver, you figure it's a gimme.
But you saw there was no separation. That was a great job by Duren, being able to keep pace with him.
Back-to-back series, swinging out for this high-octane Ole Miss offense. And out off the side of the foot and out of bounds at the 46-yard line. So for a second time, not good, great field position for Oklahoma State. The Cowboys' only appearance came in 1945 here in the Cotton Bowl. OSU, then known as Oklahoma A&M, took on TCU. Cowboys led by quarterback Bob Fenimore, who scored two rushing touchdowns. Freshman running back Jim Spavital rushed for 120 yards and a 34-0 Oklahoma A&M victory. Fields to throw, first down, and was it caught? Waiting on a ruling, no. He had an eye on Rashawn Woods.
Well, we talked about the Mississippi defense putting pressure on Fields. Look at the cushion that Travis Johnson has to put on Rashawn Woods. So he's playing way off him, and if he continues to play that far off him, Fields is going to have to make that pass.
Yeah, you got to get it there. Got to get the ball there. That's a give me. That's a give me 7 yards.
I'll tell you what, I expect to see more of Travis Johnson right up here and pressing Rashawn Woods.
Ball. Batted down at the line of scrimmage. Ball tipped by Josh Cooper.
And, you know, Tim, you brought up an interesting point talking about Travis Johnson, and you showed two different places he was. Obviously, he's mirroring Rashawn Woods wherever he goes on the field.
Right, he's a young player. He's big, 6'1", 200 pounds. He's a physical cornerback, and I think if Rashawn Woods has one chink in his armor, it may be his ability to get off of a press.
Third and 10.
He's playing way off him, though, here again.
Get off!
Field slows to the far side and over there to get it. Rashawn's little brother, DeJuan Woods, a redshirt freshman. And they're expecting big things out of him. Hard to follow in your brother's footsteps, though.
Well, they went to DeJuan, the younger brother, because the older brother actually had triple coverage on him.
He did. They had a deep zone, three across the top, and then underneath, they had a safety underneath. Look at this up top here. Here's your guys. One, two, three guys trailing Rashawn Woods, and they only had two on the other side where his brother DeJuan was, but the second one was more up towards the flat, Tim.
Rashawn had 66 receptions during the season. DeJuan had 27. This time they go back to Big Brother.
And a face mask.
Comes in late, a face mask indeed against Johnson.
A little overzealousness.
Well, you know, I think they're going to force. This is a smart move by Mike Gundy in the offense. If they are going to play off, like Tim pointed out, we're going to take the 7 yards and just keep chucking. We're going to force you to come up and take your safety back out of the box or any extra man you have in the box. Then they'll turn the game over to Tatum Bell, the running back.
That's right. Once they do that, once they back those safeties out.
5 yard penalty.
You have to remember this OSU offense is an offense that gets averages over 180 yards on the ground per game.
10th ranked scoring offense in the NCAA, Oklahoma State Cowboys.
First and 10 down to the 30 or the 28 yard line for the Cowboys.
There's that press coverage. And they gotta like that, those matchups.
Look at that off
top. They gotta like those matchups.
The fade.
Go up top to Woods and try to come
back. Flag
gonna
come out?
No flag.
I'll tell you, it certainly looked like Travis Johnson pulled his arm down while that ball was in the air.
Well, but we've said here comes the press coverage. Here it is, right? This is press. He's up, he's pressing him, he gets his hands.
Look at the arm. Look at the arm and the hands all over him.
Hey, you gotta let him play, right, Billy?
Well, I guess. Is that the New Year's resolution?
And, you know, and this really is Rashawn Woods' specialty, though.
Getting
in
away
a hand fight
people.
And coming back to the ball.
I think Josh Fields, he knows. He wants that flag. When you're going to play up on him like that in press and man coverage, you think the favor would go to Rashawn Woods.
And Blanchard again off about 15 yards. This is Tatum Bell, who just missed slipping through that crack tackle to the 25-yard line. It'll bring up third down for the Cowboys.
That's Kelvin Robinson, the strong safety. You know, we talked about Blanchard, who's the whip safety, and the other element to that is the strong safety right there. When you play that 4-2-5.
They're interchangeable, actually. The strong safety and the whip safety, they'll mix and match. One will come down, one will stay high, and then they'll switch to give you a different look. You never know who is who.
Gain of 3, 3rd and 7.
Showing the blitz.
And again, Rashawn Woods just on that slant pattern off the line of scrimmage, but the throw wasn't there.
That's the adjustment. That's the adjustment you have to make. You have the blitz. Your receivers know they're going to take the slant pattern. And it was open. It was there. Josh Fields, as you pointed out on the first drive, Tim, has to make that throw.
So far, now these are two offenses. Ole Miss averages 35 points a game. Oklahoma State averages 37 points a game, but so far it's been the defenses that have been making all the plays.
Well, that's the same old, same old. I've never been to a game that's hyped up offense versus offense that it just didn't tick the defense off, and they were the ones that took over the game.
Two of the best field goal kickers in all of college football on display here today. And as if on cue, a miss by the field goal kicker, Luke Phillips.
Bill Moss, I know you're thinking of your own Cotton Bowl here years ago, right?
Absolutely. The Pony Express against Dan Marino. Was it 7-3? We were mad.
A A slow start for the passing game of Eli Manning and company so far.
Well, you saw the two drops by Espy and then the great break on the ball by Paul Duren, the linebacker. But, you know, the drops can be corrected, Tim, for Ole Miss. You know, Eli's had the ball on the money. On the other side of it, Josh Fields for Oklahoma State hasn't been as accurate.
That's right. You know, whatever happens today, Eli Manning has been a part of a resurgence of this once proud college program.
David Cutcliffe in his fifth year at Ole Miss looking for his 40th win. Cutcliffe served for 17 years as an assistant at Tennessee. And a strike to Chris Collins. To the 43, first down, the first down for the Rebels.
This is more of what you expect from Ole Miss's offense. You've got man-to-man coverage. Durant Williams is actually the best cornerback that OSU has, but Collins gets the separation ability that you talked about earlier.
Well, you saw what Durant Williams did. He made great contact, and he carried him, but then he looked to see where his safety help was. And when he looked, that's when Collins separated.
Collins, another guy who's had an outstanding career, and he's going to get the football again. And a missed block in an open field tackle after the missed block by Williams.
I wouldn't say missed block. I'd say yeah. Durant Williams made one heck of a play out there.
Hey, I like this kid.
I do,
when,
too.
When I've watched him, we've watched heck. How many games do we watch both these teams? I think all of them. And number nine just kind of jumps out at you all the time. He's always around the ball. He's making plays on the ball. He's a heady, fast ball kind of guy that he gets his nose there. He's always around it.
Runner in motion on a second and 40. Really a fumbled snap. And a rare carry for the junior Rick Rosato, and he's got enough for a first down.
Tommy, do you remember watching his dad play?
Absolutely. For the Cincinnati Bengals.
Same name, Rick Rosato. He played there for about 4 or 5 years, 80 to 84. And they're from Ohio. He stayed in Ohio.
Yep, Milford, Ohio, a suburb of Cincinnati, about 25 miles outside of town in the east. They play good football there. High school. Especially.
Pennsylvania's not too bad either.
Not bad at all. About I knew it was coming.
About New York.
Oh.
Good hot dogs. Down on the island.
Of course, you know everybody at home is screaming about what about the football in Texas and Oklahoma. First down and maybe a gain of two for Tremaine Turner.
Well, let's not stop there. Let's not stop there with Oklahoma football and Texas football. Let's go to Mississippi as well.
Absolutely.
You think about the names that have come out of the state of Mississippi that have gone on to become legendary NFL players.
More NFL players per capita out of Mississippi than any other state in the nation. There's only 2 million people in Mississippi.
Well, that's why it's more per capita.
Well, that's what I'm saying, but you get a heck of a lot of them.
You can make stats win any way you want.
That's still pretty good. Yeah. It tells you there's good football down there.
Nearly intercepted by Williams on a dangerous throw to Bill Flowers.
Yeah, that's not a matchup I want to go to. You know, nothing against Flowers. We've seen him, again, on film, we've seen him make some nice plays. But Durant Williams is not only, we saw the tackle he made earlier, he's not only a good open field tackler, but he has a great nose for the ball.
Well, look what he did. Look how he just sidestepped Mario Hill. And just like he did with a big offensive lineman, he'll work his way, Durant Williams, to the ball.
I'd like to be his agent.
You can work it out. You're a lawyer, right?
Yeah.
We'll get to that, more on that in a minute.
There you see Eli Manning. This is what he does. He knows the offense so well, he adjusts it to the defense.
An eye on Collins.
Look at that.
And he breaks a tackle to the 20, to the 17. We talked so much about Woods, this kid Collins. What a great career he has had at Ole Miss.
Unbelievable for the last 3 years. Over 50 receptions each year. Look at the distance they gave off. All those little short passes outside were for man-to-man defense. They got out of man-to-man and went zone, and Collins just cut them up.
Did you see Eli Manning's eyes? He knew right where he was going. He read that defense. He changed the play, and he picks up another first down.
Ole Miss on the move, a fake to Turner, and Turner's wide open. Touchdown.
That was a Deuce McAllister type adjustment to the football.
Twenty-eighth touchdown pass of the season by Eli Manning for Tremaine Turner, just his second touchdown reception.
Outstanding drive put together by Ole Miss. John Lattina, their offensive line coach and coordinator.
Jonathan Nichols, the winner of the Lou Groza Award as the nation's best field goal kicker, makes it 7-0 Ole Miss. The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox is brought to you by SBC, going beyond the call. Ole Miss leading 7-0, 4:55 to play in the opening quarter. And a very impressive drive for the Rebels.
Very impressive. And you know what, too, Tom? They changed the field position on Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State, Tim, had opportunities. They didn't accomplish what they set out to do by deferring on the kickoff. They held them down there. They got the ball back twice and couldn't find a way to get points.
And then Ole Miss stayed with the passing game. Eli Manning, who was 0 for 3 on his first three passes, went 5 for 5 on that drive. He found Collins three times. And then Turner made a great adjustment to pull down the touchdown pass.
Robert Jones brings it out to the 30-yard line. So, again, pretty good field position for OSU. Well, you talk about Ole Miss football, how can you not talk about the great Archie Manning? Finished his career at school records for total offense, overall touchdowns. Named Ole Miss's team of the century in 92. And he's here today and joins Brian Baldigan. Baldy.
Thanks, Tom. I'm joined by the famous son here in Mississippi, Archie Manning. And Archie, it's got to be an emotional day for you. I mean, you've been sitting with the Rebel fans for 5 years watching your son. What's that feel like for you today?
Well, it's the end of a lot of fun, Brian. And, you know, and Olivia and I have been blessed with almost 10 years of this after following Peyton in Tennessee. We love college football, and we're just so blessed to have children that have played now for, you know, two of them at two different places. So I can't be sad about it because, you know, our cup's run over with getting to follow our kids.
Well, you talk about the resurgence of Mississippi football. Certainly your son has had a lot to do with that. You watch Eli on that last drive, Archie. How much has the game changed? Could you go out there and play in today's game with all the different changes on defense and all the different things that he has to do with the line of scrimmage now?
No, it's a cerebral game for quarterbacks now, and it you know, the pro game is so complicated, and I think a lot of the college coaches feed off of that and mix all these defenses. It's become so much specialized, and all these college quarterbacks out here, they got to think. I just ran around and threw it to somebody. It was a lot easier back then.
How about if you go back and enjoy the rest of the game, Archie? Thanks for joining us. Okay, you bet. Tom, back up to you.
Thank you very much, Brian. Thank you, Archie. A rare carry for Sean Willis. He only got 28 touches the entire year. He gets a first down crossing midfield, and a late flag comes in.
Speaking of running around, that's what OSU is starting to do. That run game is now working. First Vernon Morrissey, and now Willis, the fullback. Two big runs in a row.
Speaking about how cerebral the NFL game has become.
Dead ball, personal foul. Offense. The play resulted in the first down following the 15-yard penalty. First and 10.
That's why Tim, myself, and Brian are where we're at. Right here.
Why, because of penalties? the personal fouls?
The cerebral part of the game, okay, that Archie was talking about.
Passed us by a little bit.
Well, Les Miles just shaking his head after that personal foul was called after back-to-back big runs by Morrissey and Willis. Movement along the line, flag will come in. And a gain of maybe a yard for Morrissey, who took over after Tatum Bell was injured earlier this season. And Morrissey had back-to-back 200-plus yard rushing games as a backup.
Well, Morrissey is the kind of runner that will make you miss.
Defense, 5-yard penalty.
Whereas
first and five.
Tatum Bell is your speed guy. You want to get Tatum Bell to the edge. You want to have Morrissey making guys miss in the middle.
Well, what you have there is you're going to get six in the box, and that's why we've seen all these runs by OSU. Watch, they're coming out with six guys in the box. Here's your front four, and then 5-6. This is the weak side backer that's come up to be 7.
Ball,
he's
down
out of there.
Roll it up top for Woods, and he caught. Wow.
Oh, oh my.
That's what he excels at.
That is his gift.
And that's why, in my mind, he's an All-American. I know this is the year of the wide receiver in college football, but when you score 7 touchdowns in one game, as he did this year, an NCAA record, all-time record, you've got to be somebody's All-American. He's mine.
Travis Johnson, you know, he can't believe what he saw. He had excellent coverage, but Woods just seems to make those catches. He seems to pull them down out of the sky.
And it's not as if, Tim, he goes up and after him.
No.
You know? He's like a Randy Moss. He doesn't go up to the high point of the throw and out jump people to get him. He just has a knack for getting a little bit of separation.
Yes.
Right at the end, almost a push-off.
Yeah.
And then just harvesting the ball in with his arms and body.
I think he uses his body well to create that separation.
Well, consider, there have only been 8 receivers in the history of NCAA football to surpass 4,000 yards in receiving. Woods is one of them. And the 4th most receptions in the history of NCAA football. This is a 7-touchdown game against SMU. 7.
Count them. Can you imagine 7 touchdowns? That's almost unheard of at any level. You know, you ever go see like a Pop Warner game and you see, you know, one guy, they got one fast little guy on the team, they hand him the ball all the time, he'll run up and down the field. He'd have a hard time getting 7 touchdowns.
In that game against SMU, the 7 scores, he had 13 receptions for 232 yards overall. And we've talked about what a great career it's been for Chris Collins. He had 7 touchdown receptions the entire year.
If you ask Rashawn Woods what is he passionate about in life, one is football, catching touchdown passes. The other one is bass fishing.
Yeah, catching,
right?
Something else.
Catching largemouth bass.
Catching 8 and up. He's got his Ranger boat. He's got the big hookup, and that's all he and his brother like to do in their downtime.
That's their only vice, and that's not a vice.
Bump. And looking for the end zone. And just underthrown again. Woods, and no flag.
Where? Come on. What do you mean no flag? You can't take, when the ball's in the air, you can't turn a receiver's body around, can you?
Tell you what, Travis Johnson is a sophomore, and
watch
they
this.
Are isolating him.
Turn
and
around.
Watch him stay and stay and
no, what's,
stay.
What's that?
Oh, no. That's incidental.
Is that's incidental
doesn't
contact?
Doesn't turn him at all. Watch him. He's got his hand on him. Yeah, maybe a little at the end.
Okay. Just checking.
Just a little. I think the ball was already past him by the time he got him.
Sure,
at the
sure
end.
It was. It was too high. Overthrown. Uncatchable ball.
Second and
keep it up.
Again, Fields to throw, and again looking for Woods. And Johnson gets his hands around that one. It's 14-0 Ole Miss.
You know, Johnson's making a name for himself here quick, isn't he?
Well, he is doing a great job with his man-to-man coverage. This time, he's got some help over the top. The safety, I think it was Charles Clark was the safety. He had help over the top, so he didn't have to worry about the deep route. So he made that break on the ball.
And he read the route. You know, that's the one thing that when defensive backs, when you study film of receivers, you study where they align off the ball, how far outside the hash marks, what they do. Then you study the routes they run from it. He had that one down.
Field. The batsman, a tight end. He took a lick down to the 25-yard line. It'll bring up a decision for Les Miles very early on. They missed the field goal try a moment ago. Do they go for it? 4th and probably 2.5.
How about Badgerman?
Pre-med.
That's his 12th catch of the year. They don't use him as a receiver. They use him as a blocker. He's part of the reason that Tatum Bell has all the yards he has and all the touchdowns he has. That guy's an integral part of the blocking scheme of Oklahoma State.
Phillips missed his first field goal try today. It was his 2nd miss of the year, his 1st miss since the 1st game of the year against Nebraska. ...43-yard attempt. Good snap, and they fake it. And they're going to get the 1st down.
That's something they worked on all week in practice. It's also something that they've tried throughout the year.
Well, we've seen them on film pitch this ball to the kicker, but this time Rylant takes it himself. So the holder takes the snap, and instead of pitching it back to the kicker and going the outside, he runs it up the pipe.
Good, and you can see the defense, Tim. Sure. Notice the defense went with the kicker.
Because they saw it on film. They probably practiced it five times in the last 2 weeks.
Of course, we saw a great punt fake last night that led to the Miami Hurricanes win over Florida State in the Orange Bowl last night. They give it to Morency, trying to turn the corner and run out of bounds at the 11.
I know you get tired of seeing this and hearing it, but I love a receiver who is a team player.
That's right.
And you don't get all the rushing yards unless you get your top receiver down there blocking the heck. He can hold a little bit. That's okay. For all the holding he got on his pass route,
that's right.
He's entitled to it. Rashawn Woods came down and sealed that corner. He hit Travis Blanchard and sealed that corner for Tatum Bell.
Well, that's the one thing that you do have to do to play in the National Football League as a receiver. It's not all about catching. And Woods just showed that he's all for it right there.
Did you tell anybody up in Minnesota that?
Morency again.
Hey, I'll tell you what. Woods got another block.
Morency inside the five, a yard shy of the first down. Oklahoma State trying to knot this one up.
The number 12 rushing unit in all of college football, the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And you don't become that just by having a good running back or maybe two. You know, most of the people in the nation, if you're watching this game, you say, wait a second, who's that? Morency? Who's this? Who's Tatum Bell? You know? If you're outside of the state of Oklahoma, look at that carry. You don't know what this unit does. And when you get that kind of success running, it takes everybody out there, as you saw from Rashawn Woods.
What effort. Trying to get in and done.
What effort.
Now we got a shootout brewing.
Set up thanks in large part to the fake field goal by the Cowboys.
You know, gutsy call, too. You know what I mean? It really is.
It was a smart call, though, Billy, because instead of running the fake that they've run this season, they ran the counter to that fake.
Still gutsy. Not many head coaches.
Can't you be smart and gutsy?
Yeah.
Okay.
7-7 game.
You just want to argue with me, don't you?
You made a career out of it.
Oh, thank you.
Morency getting all the carries on this Oklahoma State drive, capped off by a four-yard score.
Watch after the first contact, Morency. He gets hit here, and he just fight again, three times on his way to the goal line, and nothing was going to stop Morency.
You know, the guy he runs through, see Travis Blanchard, 13 right here? He runs through him. Remember we talked earlier, he's the whip safety. So he's the guy that's got to cover receivers, but he also has to make run plays. He only weighs about 185 pounds, and Morency runs right through him.
And that's where, if anything, this defense becomes a weakness inside the 10-yard line.
Absolutely.
Because you don't have a guy that can take on the run down there, and you cover a slot receiver or a back out of the backfield. And both teams run this defense. And this defense is becoming even more prevalent, not only through college football, but in the NFL. When you think about the weak linebacker position in the NFL, it is actually becoming that, a whip safety, a guy that can cover a slot receiver or be stout enough to sit in there and take on the run.
Ideally, though, they can not only run, but they got to weigh in at about 225.
That one way out of the end zone. So we figured a high-scoring game. It took both teams a little while to get it cranked up, but now 7-7 here in the opening quarter.
There's the fake. That was the key to it all, as Tim pointed out. And then once they got down inside there, nothing, or nobody, I should say, was going to deny Morency from getting that ball to the end zone.
Oklahoma State, ironically enough, great field position. Its first two possessions couldn't get any points. And then they get it at their own 31 and march down the field to tie the game. first carry of the day for Deshaun Pearson, the sophomore out of Ripley, Mississippi, and he's out to the 23-yard line.
This Mississippi offense really reminds you a lot of an NFL offense, right? I mean, they come out, they do a lot of regular people, two wide receivers. They'll run a lot of I formation, one tight end, and they like to run the ball on first and second down. They like to run it, and then they can use their play action pass on third down.
And that man was the one that has run this offense. He ran it the whole time at Tennessee. Cutcliffe now runs the same offense here with the same last name and a great quarterback.
And dropped off close to a first down. And getting the first down, the ball came loose, but did the ground cause the fumble? Lorenzo Townsend lost it. But they're saying that the ground caused the fumble, and it is enough for a first down.
That was Darrett Williams again, Billy, making a play out here on the perimeter. There's the tackle. And then the ground clearly did cause that, so it is not a fumble.
When you're down, you're down.
Look at that picture. I think these guys aren't giving up their bodies to win this Cotton Bowl.
Well, we talked about two programs very much on the rise in Ole Miss and Oklahoma State. And they are both elated to be playing in this game. Manning lost it up. Intercepted. John Holland brings it back to the 35.
Oklahoma State came with a delayed blitz. Watch what they do. I believe it's the whip safety they bring down.
Yeah. And they shift the entire secondary
over to Chris Collins
to a zone.
Take a look. Right here is where the blitz is going to come around the outside.
Look,
now when they do that,
right there,
here comes Holland.
That's it.
To the outside. They roll the coverage to the two receiver side. They get on top and underneath Chris Collins. Outstanding defensive scheme and an outstanding defensive play by the Oklahoma State Cowboys.
The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox, brought to you by SBC, going beyond the call, by Southwest Airlines, friendly nonstop service all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom, by long-lasting Energizer. Do you have the bunny inside? And by American Wedding, now on DVD and video, available rated and unrated.
Well, we've talked about what goes on in Eli Manning's head all game long. This time, Oklahoma State's defense, they trick him. They make a late adjustment, and you're going to see the safety right there, Vernon Holland. He comes late to the zone. Eli Manning thinks he's got man coverage. He thinks Collins has got it beat. But here comes Holland on the zone.
That was Manning's second interception in the last 103 attempts.
Holland getting his third interception of the season. They pitch it to Tatum Bell. Back in there for Warrensey, and he went head on colliding with Travis Johnson.
Ring my bell. That's what Tatum Bell was.
Is that what you were thinking of last night? I saw you in the lobby with your hand. You had the thinker position.
Was that it?
It's beautiful.
Watch this. You've seen this play before. A little toss outside, misdirection, get the defense going one way. And Bell is a guy that's his game right there.
The thing I like about him,
once he turns a corner, he's taking it downhill.
He's got great speed, but he'll put his shoulder down too.
Bunch group up top.
Play fake to Bell. And then they set up a screen. And enough for a first down to Gabe Lindsey. First time we've called his name. First reception today for Lindsey.
Tom, which one of these teams came the furthest to get here at Cotton Bowl?
You mean travel-wise?
Yeah.
Well, I got to believe it was Ole Miss.
So are you telling me that Oklahoma State took less miles to get here?
Oh, wow. Wow, you've been working that up for days.
Wow. Well, maybe that was what you were thinking about in the lobby.
Yeah.
That was undoubtedly it. Slip through is Tatum Bell. You know, when we talk about Bell, and Billy, you brought up a great point earlier about not many people maybe outside of Oklahoma, and those who follow Big 12 football know much about Bell, but you consider the sixth all-time leading rusher at Oklahoma State, trailing only Thurman Thomas, number one, and four others, and only alongside David Thompson, Bell, the other OSU back to have back-to-back 1,000-yard rushing seasons.
Well, you know why it's Thurman Thomas he trails and not Barry Sanders? Because Barry Sanders had to wait 2 years for Thurman Thomas to graduate.
Right.
Or else it would be Barry Sanders, who is here today.
Bell can't slip out of the tackle. Michael Bozeman, the sophomore, into the game for the first time and drags Bell down. There you see some of the names, and that is a very impressive list.
Absolutely. Every one of them, I believe.
Well, look at Thomas, 4,595 yards, 14 better than Terry Miller.
A lot of tradition down there at Oklahoma State.
And they're very excited about their future.
And this is where you want to go to Rashawn Woods.
You got press up top.
Third and seven.
Little got it, Jim.
Did he get it?
He got an interference. Finally, is what he got.
I don't know. That may be an offensive pass interference.
You think he
Billy?
Pushed off?
Yeah, I do.
Bill LaMagne, our referee today.
Out of bounds.
I was wrong.
Pass interference, defense. The penalties decline. The plays results. First down.
I tell you, either way, this is the guy you want to go to. It's a third down situation.
Well, there's the contact.
I thought he did push off. I thought Woods pushed off.
You were better off on your last comment.
There he goes, right there. What a great catch.
I was wrong.
And again,
and you kind of said that like Fonzie, too. Remember Fonzie said I was wrong?
Yeah.
I was woo. he just couldn't get it out.
I was worried about going to Woods.
Absolutely.
But then I negated it by being wrong. I'll just be quiet.
Play fake to Bell. Fields rolling right. And just throws it away. Starting to say a moment ago, of course, in a college game, you only have to get 1 foot in bounds as opposed to two at the pro level. And it looked like Woods got the knee down in bounds anyway.
Right. You know, and Tim, when you alluded to it, is watching game film of Rashawn Woods. One thing that always comes out is his little push-off he has. He has that Michael Irvin just gets his body into a guy and pushes off just for a little bit of separation right when the ball is about to get there.
He does it with an elbow a lot of times. Yeah.
Like a basketball player would.
Exactly. And he uses his body.
All the way down to the 4 yard line goes Tatum Bell. So to bring up third down for the Cowboys, trying to take the lead for the first time today.
And Oklahoma State is getting their offensive game together by running the football. They're playing a little game with Ole Miss in the aspect of how many people are you going to have in that box area? And if you're going to defend the pass with Rashawn Woods, then I'm going to pound you inside.
Well, the run, defending the run has been a struggle for Mississippi all week.
101 out here. They're all stacked in the middle.
Touchdown.
And it doesn't matter. Right behind the fullback, Sean Willis, goes Tatum Bell, and it didn't matter how many men they had in the box. Oklahoma State, when they smell that goal line, their guys know how to find it.
Yeah, they wanted the line of scrimmage, because as you pointed out, the defenders had the box stack. They had the men, but they didn't have the muscle.
That is his 16th touchdown this season for Tatum Bell. Good enough for a fourth post and the big 12, and the point after is good by Phillips. So after falling behind 7-0, OSU indeed has it rolling. And they've opened a 7-point lead with 11:30 to play in the first half. This week the NFL second season begins. One will emerge. Mike Holmgren comes to Green Bay as a head man of Seattle. Against his former team and former quarterback Brett Favre and the Packers. Coverage of the NFC Wildcard Playoffs begins Sunday, noon Eastern, 9 Pacific, only on Fox. How do you guys see that?
Oh, he didn't have a good trip when he went up there earlier in the season. Yeah. Was it 31-3 or they just Green Bay put it to him up there at Lambeau.
And Brett Favre is just playing on high-octane emotion. Of course, his dad passed away a couple weeks ago. And, heck, talk about Mississippi. You know, Kill, Mississippi is where he's from. His dad was his high school teacher, high school coach. Passed away on the weekend, and Brett played brilliantly on Monday night and last week as well.
Last week, 2 weeks ago, throwing Monday night, throwing that. How about the touchdown pass to an Ole Miss alum in Wesley Walls?
First down, play fake, man to the air. And what a catch reaching behind him. The rarely used Lawrence Lilly. He has caught three balls all season long.
They like this guy. They think this guy has the NFL look, like a prototypical type tight end. Watch him just run down the seam. I mean, he went down the seam and nobody picked him up behind the linebackers, in front of the safeties, and the one-handed grab.
And they know he's got the hands. I mean, you look at the size of him. He is a big man who can block, and now we know he can also catch.
No lily pad that can handle that guy. 21-yard gain. A redshirt freshman is Lilly. And they hand it off to Pearson. And he gets maybe two.
What you're going to see from Mississippi is a mixture of running backs.
What I saw out of Oklahoma State right there, Tim, was pursuit. Because they had the point of attack block. They, being Ole Miss, they had that perimeter block, and it was the pursuit from the backside, just effort and hustle that got there that stopped that play from becoming anything.
Short drop and a strike, and what a hit by Williams.
Now you're starting to see some of the things I like about that guy.
You see him all. He makes play after play. Now there's a little bit of a cushion, but watch him make the break, and he just drops Chris Collins.
The break, the stop and break. When he recognized what it was, stopping his back pedal and accelerating forward onto the ball all in one move.
And you're talking about a guy who's playing for the first time since he had to leave the Oklahoma game with an injury. First team all Big 12 performer, Williams. Manning wide open to Bill Flowers. First down to the 37-yard line.
Wait, this is a third down and one situation. This is the confidence they have in Eli Manning, right? He looks to the outside. He pump fakes to Edwards. Watch Eli Manning. Watch him right here. He pump fakes. There's the pump. And then he waits. And then he sees his man open on the inside seam. And he delivers the pass just before Greg Richmond gets it.
Manning was hit on 9 of 14 for 118 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. And he'll give it off again to Deshaun Pearson. A running back by committee that Ole Miss likes to use, Turner, Pearson, and McClendon. Combined, they rush for better than 1,300 yards during the season, but the passing game is their game.
You know, what about the job this man's done right here, Tim? Cutcliffe. He was the offensive coordinator for Peyton Manning at Tennessee for all those years. Won the top assistant award, the Broyles Award, while he was at Tennessee. And he brought that same offense to Ole Miss.
Well, he's been to 20 bowl games in his coaching career. He knows how to win. He knows the formula. And he's done it. I mean, he has brought Ole Miss back to national prominence.
Brandon Pearson slipped the tackle, and he has a first down to the 25-yard line.
I think the most difficult job in sports is to take a program that's struggling, especially in college football,
right,
and turn it around, because you've got to recruit. And how can you recruit
on
if
something
you've got
you
a losing
have
program?
Yeah,
and exactly, of course, those in the Big 12, I mean, even the Oklahoma State faithful would have to say, arguably the greatest turnaround by any coach in the last 50 years in college football is the job that Bill Snyder has done at Kansas State.
Well, and I think Les Miles on the other side of the field has done a great job, too. Both coaches today have done the same thing.
Manning to the end zone. And this time, SB hangs on.
Eli Manning, as we said, this is the offense his brother ran. Cutcliffe ran it at Tennessee for Peyton Manning, and Eli knows it. He's studied it for 9 years. Heck, he has Peyton Manning study his game films, break them down. They talk every Thursday night about defenses and how to attack them, and that was just a brilliant vision and a throw by Eli Manning.
Jonathan Nichols, a point after. 96 consecutively he's hit on, and Manning his second touchdown pass of the game. The shootout is on in Dallas. The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox is brought to you by Acura. Experience the performance today at your local Acura dealer. Boy, look at that little angel rooting on Eli and the Rebels. Wow.
You know, there was a new safety in the game. It was Freddie Sinclair on that play. He was number 13. And he's a young man that really hasn't had much experience. But the reason he's in is I believe there was an injury on the tackle to Darren Williams. We talked about that break that he made on the ball and coming up and on that tackle. I think he may have got injured.
And again, booted out of the end zone. So at 14 apiece, we'll take a timeout. Catch your breath. The next offense is coming on the field. A big injury for Oklahoma State. For more on that, here's Brian Baldinger.
Yeah, Tom, I'm down here right in front of the Oklahoma State defensive bench. I'm looking at Darren Williams. He came off in that last series, and he pulled his left quad muscle. It's a serious pull. He's tried to walk it off. He's told the coaches right now that he can't go in right now, but he's going to ice it down, and then he's going to see how it is in the second half.
Well, that certainly explains how come the receiver was wide open in the end zone. It looked like a breakdown in coverage.
So now the Cowboys turn, and wow, what a throw that was by Fields to Rashawn Woods.
Yeah, I don't know if we've talked enough about Josh Fields as a passer, because that pass right there was just laid in perfectly, because the zone coverage was underneath, and you look at the arc on this ball, and it's got to clear the underneath zone, and he drops it in perfectly,
Timmy,
to Rashawn Woods.
That's the high bouncer over to the hot corner over the third base bag. He had to jump to make that turnaround throw to first base.
That was beautifully done. I don't know about the high bouncer and all that stuff. I'm not a baseball guy, but
Billy, I knew where you were going.
Tom is.
And out to the 43-yard line goes Morency. They've been alternating between Morency and Tatum Bell. And both have run the ball very well early on. That's been the story all year.
And here's the big guy right here, Mays. He's 350 pounds. Look at the
drive that he has. Look at the way that thing opened. You're big Mays. You talked about it. He's out of Ohio. He's a junior, 350 pounds. You know, some guys try Richard Simmons, some guy tried Jenny Craig. He is all about Sarah Lee.
I'll tell you what, and he can move too. That's the thing.
The whole side of that line. Did you see the whole side of that line?
That's the same thing, you know, that they did down on the goal line, right? I mean, they were able to just barrel in once they got inside the 20.
And you see, you get a look at number 75. Corey Hilliard is in the game for the first time, a true freshman out of New Orleans. They love the right side of their line, looking for years to come.
Only six men on the line of scrimmage. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Well, actually, he's wrong. Because you can count two men for Mays. So that would be seven men, and that's who you have to have on the line of scrimmage, seven.
The Sarah Lee and the heaviness and all that. The thing that makes these guys special is their movement. They've got quick feet. You wouldn't think it. If you saw them in the grocery store, you'd say there's no way they could beat me to the check.
Because they're hungry.
But
they swing it out, and close to midfield is DeJuan Woods.
You know what I really like that Oklahoma State's doing? Mike Gundy talked about him at the top, it being the offensive coordinator. Yeah.
Spreading it around.
Yeah, I mean, they go way out to the far left. They go way out to the far right. They'll gash you in the middle. There's Gundy, the offense coordinator, who was the quarterback at Oklahoma State with that 88 team that put up 522 points with Barry Sanders, with Hartley Dykes. You know, that's... I asked him about Josh Fields, and I said, when I see him play, he reminds me of you. And he said, absolutely.
Said
it's the same thing. Yeah.
Gundy did say, though, that he, Gundy, ran it a little better, had a little better footwork, but that Fields had a little bit better arm.
Yeah. And the thing about it is they're really smart individuals as far
good
as
offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Well, for some of you, we apologize for some of our technical difficulties. We think we've gotten them straightened out, so bear with us.
Are you talking about me and Tim again?
That's precisely who I was talking about.
Well, we apologize.
I've been
for
called
us
difficult,
as well.
But not technically difficult.
But what Gundy does offensively in that offense, okay, is spreading it all over the place. And Tim, as two defensive guys, you know, playing in that kind of against that offense really frustrating.
Yeah, it puts you on your heels. You don't know where to go.
Not much room there for Morenci, and a good play by the middle linebacker LP Spence playing in his final game for Ole Miss.
Spence was not on his heels.
He was.
He hit that in the line of scrimmage with a full head of steam.
The thing about the quarterback position that both Gundy and Josh Fields had is it's the same offense. It's the same offense that Gundy had. And what he does is they move. You're going to watch the tight ends move and shift to each side. See, there it goes right there. There goes that shifting. Just ran across Fields' face. And they set what they want the defense to be in and then try to take advantage of it.
Swinging out from Morenci, got the tackler, and he is dragged out of the 49-yard line. And a late flag comes in.
As I said earlier, Morenci is the running back that can make you miss.
There's clothes out there on the field. I see a couple pieces of clothing. I mean, he just slammed on the brakes. I mean, you talk about stopping on a dime. You know, when you're over 200 pounds and he's about 225, look at that. Just be able to stop your body's momentum and not move an inch. And then be able to accelerate upfield. You talk about athletic ability.
That is a huge penalty against Ole Miss. It was going to be third and 11 for Oklahoma State. Instead, it's first and 10, and they go all the way down to the 36-yard line. Morenci, another one of those players who gave baseball a try. How many college players have we seen go that route here and then come back to football after failing in the minor leagues trying to reach a major league?
Ball.
Fields fires and overthrows, looking for the end zone and had an eye on Tommy Devereaux.
He rushed that, and I think he rushed it because Josh Cooper, Mississippi's defensive end, had a good pass rush. We've talked about the strength of OSU is in the center of the line. Here's Josh Cooper right here, and you're going to see him rush around the outside. And they've got Badgham at the tight end blocking him, and you see Fields never sets his feet when he throws.
You're exactly right. And that was a bootleg, the fake handoff. And who you were talking about, Josh Cooper, he got in the path of that bootleg, and you had Fields had to hurry it up, step up in the pocket.
Fields 10 of 18 for 117 yards. Fake one way, come back to Bell the other way, and Ole Miss read it beautifully.
I think if you're going to run against Ole Miss, and of course that's a pass, but you run a swing pass like that, really what it is a glorified run, right?
It's a run.
And I think if you want to run against this defense, the way you want to do it, and where OSU's had success is running right at it. Use your big offensive linemen to try to go after their undersized defense. When you go to the perimeter, their speed can catch you.
That's a great point. Because when they have hit the middle, they've had a lot of success.
They nailed that. And they're going right up the middle. Right up the middle. And Morenci is tripped up down to the 30-yard line, which will bring up a fourth and four.
Did you hear the sound of the defense? The linebacker was calling out, draw. They knew what was coming and still couldn't defend it because of the job the blockers did up front. Did you see, was that Sean Willis that motioned back in?
Yeah.
That was Sean Willis, 37, that motioned back into the formation and laid a devastating block on the linebacker to spring that thing open.
And how about Les Miles? He had a fake field goal earlier. He's going fourth and four here.
Oh, look at the rush. They're going to bring it.
They bring it. And down he goes.
There he is. Cooper again. We saw Cooper get the pressure on the outside before. This time he comes inside. And not only does he get the pressure, he gets the sack.
He confused that offensive line. They stacked all those guys up on the line of scrimmage and only brought about three of them. It was real confusing. There's the sack. Ole Miss ball. Great field position.
We're tied at 14. Let's go downstairs to Brian Baldinger.
All right, Tom, I'm here with the chairman of the 68th SBC Cotton Bowl, Finn Ewing. And Finn, I look around this bowl today. It's completely full. We got a beautiful day. This is more than just another college football game. This is a culmination of a lot of work.
It's a lot of work. You know, most people think we work just one day a year, but we actually have a Hall of Fame, art contest, a Phil Scoble Foundation. We have just a lot of things that we do that all go into this.
A lot of activities. Listen, we watched USC beat Michigan last night. On Sunday night, we got the national championship game. We got LSU, Oklahoma. Where do you stand on a playoff game?
We are not unhappy. We think the BCS should just be tweaked a little bit. We don't think it should be thrown out. We also think that, you know, every game that you play in college football is a playoff. Every game counts. So we think that if they added one more bowl, that'd be just fine, and it should probably be the SBC Cotton Bowl Classic.
Finn Ewing, thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the game. Tom, back up to you.
Baldy, thank you very much. Boy, we've had a terrific week here in Dallas. A 20-yard gain by Tremaine Turner. And Ole Miss back in business. They'll hand it off to Turner again. But he took a lick down at the 37-yard line. Vernon Grant, the man who delivered.
You know, before Tremaine Turner had that 20-yard run, the thing that stuck out was Eli Manning at the line of scrimmage changing the play. Now, he won't just change to a pass play. Eli Manning understands this offense so well, he can also change the running plays at the line of scrimmage.
Ole Miss going to spend a timeout. First they've used here in the first half. We'll be back with 3:12 to play.
Being a difference maker starts with being different. And at Oklahoma State University, what's different is the people. Here, people put people first, and all the rest follows. Like balance academically, athletically, culturally, and socially. We're proud of our program excellence and state-of-the-art technologies. But what makes OSU different is the faculty, administrators, staff, and most importantly, the students who create this unique community. And that's how people who make a difference out there in the world, the difference makers, are born.
Well, over the last number of decades, the SBC Cotton Bowl has been a showcase for top senior quarterbacks. Going back to 71, Joe Theismann, Joe Montana, in 79. Your old buddy at Pitt, Dan Marino. Doug Flutie still going after all these years with BC, was here in 1985. And Troy Aikman out of UCLA in 1989.
That's just a few of them. This Cotton Bowl has held the memories on this field of some of the best names that ever played football at any level.
Second down throw for Manning, and again wide open over the middle. The big tight end, Lawrence Lilly, his second catch today. We mentioned earlier he only caught three passes the entire year.
When you look at the size of him and you see the elusiveness and the hands, you got to think that Eli Manning is going to keep looking to him.
Darren Williams is back out on the field at his corner spot. So they've got their defense back intact.
And they've got him up there across from Chris Collins, Mississippi's number one receiver.
To the 22.
Looked a little slow that time. A little, just, you know how you're tentative, Tim? You know how you've been injured before and you take yourself back in the game?
Yeah.
And anytime it's anything below the waist, well, you know, and you try to get back out there and do something, but you're always just kind of feeling your way through each step.
And did you see Collins? I think Collins, Chris Collins, probably knows it. and they may want to go to it. They may want to try to take advantage of the injury.
Turnover to the big hole. For the 14, first down, Ole Miss.
Boy, what a great call. And, you know, Peyton Manning is really the one responsible. When he senses, I'm sorry, Eli Manning. When he senses that they're going to come with a blitz to one side, he's in control of that offense. He has the ability to check to anything that's going to get them away from the blitz. And that time, it was a run away from the blitzing side.
And you could give Peyton part of the credit. Film breakdown and everything.
And going to traveling all the way up to Tennessee to watch him, and then going to the summer camps with Coach Cutcliffe. Heck yeah.
Again, 2 yards, holding up second down.
I had a chance yesterday at practice, or 2 days ago, to talk to Archie Manning about Eli and Peyton. And he said, you know, and my older son Cooper, the thing we're most proud of is the relationship that these guys have with each other, and how good they are to each other, and how busy Peyton is with his own career up in Indianapolis.
And they talk to each other every Thursday during the season.
And how he helps his younger brother, breaking down film and helping him with his offensive game plan.
Collins. And his knee touched the ground, and he is down. That is a rule in college football. Any part of your body makes contact with the ground, you are down.
Just a little screen pass outside, and he had to go down on his knees to catch the ball, and that's where it's going to stay.
And now third down. At the Oklahoma State 15.
See the check? See, you see the linebacker move up in here? Now Peyton Manning.
And now
I'm sorry, Eli Manning. He calls it out.
Short drop. Intended for Collins and defended beautifully by Robert Jones.
There was a slant. You know, and that's what you go to a lot of times when you have that blitzing linebacker in the middle. The slant play or the post play in this case, well, you take your shot.
When you see a cornerback play this slant route like this after they show the blitz, you got to credit Bill Clay, the defensive coordinator for Oklahoma State.
Because they understand what the offense is going to adjust to.
You know that his players have seen it in practice, and they're seeing it now, and they're defending.
This guy's not too bad, huh?
Not bad at all. Mentioned earlier, the Lou Groza Award winner for the nation's top field goal kicker. And Nichols is good on this try. Put on 25 of 29 on the year. That one from 33 yards. And Ole Miss has recaptured the lead by 3.
Oklahoma State 14.
A reminder, coming up, our Cotton Bowl halftime show. We'll listen to the bands from both schools, Oklahoma State and Ole Miss. And first half analysis from Bill and Tim.
You know what's great about college football to me is the bands. You know, and when you look around and you see all the orange here from Oklahoma State and all the red and blue here from Mississippi, you know, it's just they all share the same thing. They're not just fans of a team. They've all been to the student union. They've all been to the library. You know, they've all been to the Grove. They've all been to Eskimo Joe's down in Stillwater. You know, they've all been a part of that whole scene and the whole experience. And it ties you in almost, you know, an emotional thing to your heart, your being, your fiber is tied to the belief and the tradition of your university. And it's so much fun.
And especially in a small town.
Yeah, I think you talk about small towns, and we talked about Mississippi and how they put out so many great football players. And the reason is Mississippi is a lot of small towns. I mean, you go there on a Friday night, you're going to a football game.
Lee Rogers will kick it off. And waiting back for the Cowboys. Warren C. and Jones. And this will be Jones for the 25.
Say what I love. I love you talk about everyone being together. I love looking down and seeing a just a swath of orange, and then you see a swath of red. It's
If you look at the end zone, if you take a look at the end zone through the goalpost,
look at it right there. Right,
isn't that unbelievable? right down the middle. That is absolutely right down the middle here. They're sitting beside each other there, and on the other side of where it's closed and there's no tunnel, it goes all the way down to the field. Look at that. Look at that. Is that beautiful?
Yeah.
Right down. Look, Oklahoma State and Mississippi the other. Beautiful.
Well, as we expected, a lot of offense in the opening half. And Ole Miss led by Eli Manning in his final game for the Rebels. A 17-14 lead. Let's go downstairs to Brian Baldinger.
Not yet.
Waiting momentarily for Brian to talk with David Cutcliffe, and now the coaches come over. Brian, down to you.
Hey, Tom, thanks. Coach Cutcliffe, it's a heck of a first half of football. What do you got to do here in the second half to secure this win and pull out this Cotton Bowl win?
Well, we've got to defend Rashawn Woods. We can't let him make big plays on us. We've got to try to consistently, when we run the football consistently, we're going to make plays ourselves.
All right, Coach, good luck to you in the second half.
You bet.
Tom, back up to you.
So David Cutcliffe's team trying to get a 10-win season. It has already been a breakout year for Ole Miss. Oklahoma State will have something to say about that back after a break from your local station. The color, the pageantry of college football, and we welcome the Cowboy Marching Band, the spirit of Oklahoma State, formed in 1900, 250 members strong. Welcome back to the SBC Cotton Bowl, and now time to listen in and enjoy the pride of the South, the University of Mississippi Marching Band. Ole Miss in front, 17-14 at halftime. And now enjoy the finale of this 2004 SBC Cotton Bowl halftime extravaganza.
You are watching Fox Sports.
The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox is brought to you by SBC Going Beyond the Call, by Office Max, What's Your Thing, by Southwest Airlines, friendly nonstop service to all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. And by WebMD, redefining modern medicine. You talk Oklahoma State football, one of the first names that comes to mind, Barry Sanders. Let's go downstairs to Brian Baldinger.
Well, I'm with Oklahoma State's most famous alumni. 15 years ago, he won the Heisman Trophy. I'm with Barry Sanders. Barry, Happy New Year. I mean, it's got to be a good feeling to see Oklahoma State football back in prominence.
It is. It's very good. A lot of the fans have been waiting for the team to really come around and come to a game like this. So a lot of people are excited about this today.
Barry, does this team remind you of the team that you played on, the couple bowl games that you went to when you were at Oklahoma State?
Somewhat. Yeah, this team definitely has a lot of offensive power. But obviously, you know, on the other sideline, they have some pretty good offense, too. But, yeah, the Oklahoma State offense, you know, you got a great receiver, a good quarterback, and a running back that they're expecting big things out of. So, yeah, there are some similarities.
Barry, enjoy the action here today. Take it back upstairs, Tom.
Boy, does the NFL miss Barry Sanders. More on that, I guess, some other time. But we talked about offense at the very beginning of this game, Tim Green. We talked, of course, about Eli Manning. And except for one little hiccup, he has been as advertised today.
Yeah, he hasn't disappointed. Even Barry Sanders, the great player, referring to the offensive firepower. And, of course, that is Eli Manning. Now, he started out and he went 0-for-3, had some drops. And then he got into a rhythm. And we saw great passes, We saw great decisions. We saw Eli Manning adjusting his offense to the defense. And then we saw Oklahoma State's defense make this adjustment. They made a counter adjustment, and that was the only glitch that we've seen from Eli Manning, because after that over three and the interception, we've seen two touchdowns, and we've also seen him complete, since that first three, 13 of his last 15
Tim,
passes.
Somebody check his DNA. Do you know where Peyton is right now? His mannerisms, everything he does, point. Looks just like Peyton.
That's a good point. Yeah, he's got the dark hair, though, too. He'd have to do the DNA and the hair dye.
On the other side of the coin, you talked about Rashawn Woods, to keep an eye on him. Are they going to him enough so far in this game?
Yeah, well, they have, what was it, 75 yards he has already. And when they were giving them, playing off of him early in the game, they were throwing short passes underneath. They were trying to throw some screen passes outside and get some blockers out in front of them. And then you saw the quick passes that Tim pointed out by giving him that cushion. Then when they went man-to-man, he'd made plays. You saw that on the near sideline. And, of course, the other one on the other sideline. And as Coach Cutcliffe referred to going in at halftime, what was the one thing he said? If we're going to win this game, we've got to stop them throwing the ball to Rashawn Woods.
And earlier I saw Travis Johnson, who's had the duty to cover Rashawn Woods most of the day, get a talking to by Coach Cutcliffe. And David Cutcliffe really is an offensive guy. He's focused a lot on the offense. But that is the highlight for Mississippi's defense. They really want to clamp down on Rashawn Woods. That might, Billy, open things up even more for Oklahoma State's running game.
Well, they've been playing off each other hand in hand. It all depends on what Mississippi chooses to play at the line of scrimmage. They go the other way.
Oklahoma State will get it to begin the second half, and they'll get it at the 20-yard line. A moment ago, Brian Baldinger caught up with Oklahoma State head coach Les Miles.
All right, thanks, Tom. I'm with the head coach Les Miles here. And Les, heck of a football game in the first half. What do you got to do here in the second half?
Well, we have to control the football on the ground, set up some play action passing. I mean, this game, if we win the second half, we win the game. We're really, it's a brand new game.
Doesn't look like you can get the ball to Rashawn Woods enough right now.
Well, we're trying. I can tell you that. That's certainly a desire of ours.
All right, Coach, good luck to you in the second half. You bet.
Ryan, thank you very much. We mentioned a moment ago, hearing from Barry Sanders, it's the first time that Oklahoma State is making back-to-back bowl appearances since 87-88. It's only the fourth time that has happened in Cowboys football history. And a handoff to Sean Willis on a first down carry out close to the 25, a gain of 3.5.
What you talking about? Willis? I like the guy. You know, and anytime you see Morenci or Tatum Bell get anything, any kind of yards whatsoever, look for 37 leading the way. He's really the unsung hero of the rushing game.
He's physical, and I like his smarts too. A biochem major, playing fullback.
I took a class like that one time. That's how hard that class was.
I know that feeling. Swung out to the left side, and enough for a first down and then some to Rashawn's younger brother, Dewan Woods, a redshirt freshman. Some of the numbers in the first half.
Well, yeah, the passing yards, you got to jump out. It's just what they are. You look at the Rebels over here, and you look at the Cowboys over here, and it almost just jumps out and tells you, this is what we are, this is what we came here to this Cotton Bowl with, and this is what we're going to try to win with.
Oh, we're seeing two pretty balanced offenses, right, playing pretty well, and then you see the sacks by Mississippi's defense, and that kind of jumps out at you, too.
They pitch it to Tatum Bell. And he's up to the 40-yard line.
That's the second time Travis Blanchard has made a tackle right here in the second half. And he's the guy. Remember, we talked about him earlier, the whip safety. He's kind of a hybrid player. He really is the size of a defensive back. He's 185 pounds. They ask him to cover wide receivers man-to-man. He's got to make tackles. And that's the second one he made in this second half. First one he tackled was Willis.
You know what I like in Tatum Bell is his perimeter speed. You know.
Oh yeah. I love watching him. When he hits that off tackle plane, he has room. Look out. You better take a good angle downfield.
Look at that formation right there.
There is Bell, and he breaks one tackle, brings it out to the 42. Well, Bell can't fly. In high school, he ran a 4.35 40. He ran a 10.26 100.
And you know the thing we talked about earlier too. We have seen this guy put his shoulder down and try to run people over. So he's got the speed, but he also has that toughness.
Yo Quiero Tatum Bell. You didn't get that, did you?
Oh, you know I got it. Come on.
You're a late night guy.
Austin, Texas, or Arizona, or you get all that stuff. Third and three ball tipped at the line of scrimmage. It looked like Charlie Anderson got a hand on it.
Brian Baldinger just said they need to get it more to Rashawn Woods. We didn't see them get it to Rashawn Woods on that drive. They got it to DeJuan.
I think they need to go back to what you said, Tim, early on in the second quarter, and that's rely on that offensive line. There is a mismatch there. Use it.
Oh, Clark puts a foot on it. And taken by Espy with lots of room in front of him. Out across the 35. Got a big-time block. Boy, and I mean a big-time block. Julius Roslin taken down on a big hit. Wow. Ole Miss getting the ball for the first time here in the second half. Let's check in with Brian Baldinger.
Tom, I'm down here with the president and CEO of SBC Southwest, Bill Blaze. And, Bill, congratulations on just an outstanding week down here in Dallas.
Thank you, Brian. We're really pleased at SBC to sponsor the Cotton Bowl Classic. Everything associated with the game is first class, from the hospitality of the Cotton Bowl committee to you and everybody at Fox for your production of this great event. The fact that we've got the two best conferences in the SEC and the Big 12, two great teams in OSU and Ole Miss, and, boy, you can't say enough about these fans. You know, they had this place sold out within 48 hours.
Bill, why are you so committed? Why is SBC so committed to this SBC Cotton Bowl?
Well, what it comes down to is SBC's fundamental commitment to education and to the communities where we live and we work. You know, for every dollar invested in the Cotton Bowl, 75 cents goes back to the schools of the Big 12 and the SEC. And in the long and storied history of the Cotton Bowl, $140 million has been generated for higher education. We think that's pretty special.
It sure is, Bill. And really, this is just the beginning of a great year for you here at SBC.
Well, we're looking forward to 2004. You know, we've been providing communication services here in the heartland, and now from in Connecticut to California for 100 years, we provide a local and long-distance voice service, internet service with Yahoo, DSL, and wireless service with Singular. And next year, we'll be providing our satellite service with SBC Dish. We'll also be providing a data network for our business customers, and we'll be expanding our wireless presence. We're looking to go beyond the call for all of our customers, looking forward to providing technology, service, and prices to meet their needs.
All right, Bill, thanks a lot for joining us here. Enjoy the rest of the game. Tom, back up to you.
Brian Baldinger playing the role of Lou Dobbs here at the Cotton Bowl.
Tommy probably couldn't have had a better sponsor for the Cotton Bowl, SBC, when one of the top players, Rashawn Woods' dad, Larry Woods, who's the father of six, including three Oklahoma State players, right, is a 30-year employee of SBC Communications.
Up
currently
in Oklahoma
a manager,
City. Yeah.
Manager for SBC Network Engineering in Oklahoma City. And also, the sister, Rosalind Stern, who's the Larry Woods' daughter, but the player's sister, oldest daughter, works for SBC right here in Dallas.
How about that?
That's kind of a family affair.
And that's all SBC.
And you know, more importantly than anything, what a job they've done in raising their family. Those are some terrific young people, not just athletes.
Yeah, I tell you, I like those three letters better than the other three letters. I like SBC.
You do?
Better than the other three letters if you change it around.
That's for sure. Manning in trouble and dumps it off complete. And good enough for a first down to Kerry Johnson.
It's the first time we've heard Kerry Johnson's name today, but he really is kind of their possession inside slot receiver.
Now, you saw Trey Stallings get taken off. He looked like he injured his leg, something took him off. And Bobby Harris, sophomore out of Decatur, Georgia, he's in at the left tackle position, number 75.
It all the way down to the the 25 and then tries to pitch it to his teammate and a scramble for the ball. Who got it?
Get out!
Poor decision there made by Tremaine Turner after a huge game. And we'll see who's underneath that pile with the football.
We have talked Pollard. About the brilliant decisions that Eli Manning has made all game long. And how he knows David Cutcliffe's offense. His brother ran it in Tennessee. Cutcliffe was Peyton Manning's coach at Tennessee. And he just makes the adjustment. We said it's not just in the passing game. He sees a defense where this run goes well. It's a good match. And then they do almost lose it. But
I tell you, they had a free tackler in the hole, too. And then John Holland, 17, just absolutely missed it.
Turner getting it. A great deal on this drive. He's caught a couple of passes. Now back-to-back runs. Picks up close to eight there, and he's down to the 15. Kareem Smith on the stop.
Yeah, take a look at the guys inside and the matchups the offensive linemen have to make and who they have to get to. Take a look down in the trenches down here. See the contact first, then they've got to try to get to the second level and get up on the linebackers. And when you're playing against Bill Clay's defense of Oklahoma State, there's bodies flying all over the place. Those guys move up and down. They shift in motion, in and out.
Runner in motion this time, and they hand it to Rosano. Rare carry for him, and he's down to the 13-yard line. Only three rushes all year long for the junior out of Ohio, Rick Rosano.
He got married. No, he got married this year? Well, not this year, 2004, but last year. Married a basketball player, Lee Henley, an Ole Miss basketball player.
So there'll be some Rosano offspring teeing him up. Well, you know, sometime down the road at Ole Miss.
He's a Rosano offspring, you know. His father played in Cincinnati. It's going to continue.
Third and short, tough to defend against Mississippi because they are very willing to let Eli Manning throw a pass.
You got 1-on-1 on the outside.
First down, Turner to the 9-yard line.
I think when that happens, when an offense has the kind of balance that Mississippi has had all season and certainly in this game, defensively it's 3rd and 1. You say, well, can we play short yardage? Can we play the short yardage run? You can't play it completely because earlier in the game they had 3rd and 1 and Manning threw the ball to the outside for the conversion. This time they go with the run, keeping the defense on its heels with offensive balance.
And they've been running over to the right side where they have Marcus Johnson, they have Cliff Woodruff, both over 300 pounds. Every run so far that's come out in the third quarter for Ole Miss has been over that right side.
Vernon Grant will leave. And let's send it downstairs to Brian Boldinger.
Yeah, Tom, just looking at the left tackle, Trey Stallings. On this drive, he injured and sprained both his left knee and left ankle. He's going to be out for a while.
Baldy, thank you very much. And again, Manning checking off at the line of scrimmage. Plenty of time on the play clock. And he'll hand it off and slip into the outside. And down to the 3-yard line is Turner. He rushed for nearly 800 yards this season. And very impressive on this drive.
Tremaine Turner is very close now to 100 yards. He's got over 80 yards. And it's this right here, this second effort. He puts his shoulder down and runs right through Holland.
You see who was up there following, 42, Rosano. That's it. That's, you know what they were talking about? They're running that right side. Then they come back with a counter and come back to the weak side and let Rosano, the fullback, lead the way.
They got to like this matchup out here.
Audible again by Manning.
Six.
Wow. Not one you can part the Red Sea like that.
Wow. I mean, they went with the single coverage on Chris Collins at the top. Oklahoma State stacked everyone up there to stop the run and still was unable to control the line of scrimmage.
The That was an offensive line. Lead blocking out of the backfield by Rosano, and Turner carried the load on that drive, the first of the second half by Ole Miss.
Tom, when you come out and you set the tone like that and you put it on your offensive line and they march down the field and score, look out.
Here is our WebMD health report. We talked about Tatum Bell, missed the last couple of games during the regular season. He's back today. Darren Williams is all right after injuring his left quad a little bit earlier. But doubtful, as Brian Baldinger told us a moment ago, that we'll see Trey Stallings again today. Out of the end zone, it'll be brought out to the 20-yard line. Oklahoma State needing points, down by 7 in the third at the 68th SBC Cotton Bowl. This year, the 50th anniversary of one of the greatest plays you'll ever see in your life. Rice running back Denny Magel awarded a 95-yard touchdown after Alabama's Tommy Lewis comes off the bench to take him down. You gotta love this.
Well, they didn't have a rule back then. They didn't, but they made one after that. And you know what? The guy came charging out there without a helmet on, too. I give him some kind of credit.
No doubt. You took the words right out of my mouth. You got to give it up to him. They go rush for 265 yards in that game.
After that, they put in the rule that if something like that were to happen, it's an automatic touchdown.
First down throw to DeJuan Woods, and good enough for a first down, a gain of close to 15.
I think with Mississippi's offense and the way Eli Manning has been playing, that it's very important for Oklahoma State to now come out and score and keep this game close. And I think that Mississippi's defense has done a good job of slowing down the Oklahoma State running game. And now I think we're going to see Oklahoma State go to the passing game. They've got to make it work.
Fields play fake in trouble. Rose on the run. And nearly intercepted.
I'll tell you what, if they're going to get that passing game going, Tim, they better find a way to slow down that rush. Because Mississippi boys, they are coming after them. They're smelling what you're smelling. And they are getting a jump off the line of scrimmage. There's Cooper being drugged down by Davis, I believe.
Yeah, the other guy who you saw in there was Ken Borns, who's the middle linebacker. And what that tells you is that Ole Miss is going to bring the pressure. They're going to blitz, and they're going to force Josh Fields to make decisions quickly.
NASCAR
coming up, right? Not long now.
17 weeks of it right here on Fox.
Well, if you drove on the Dallas Tollway at any time this week, it certainly felt like NASCAR.
Until this point.
Yeah.
And it was a long, long convoy of Ole Miss Rebel fans and Okie State Cowboy fans. Morency in trouble. Down he goes. Outstanding pursuit.
Yeah, Kelvin Robinson, who's another, remember, he's the swing guy. He's the strong safety on the outside. And he's being blocked by Gabe Lindsey. He beats that block and slows this play down so the rest of the defense can get there.
Tim, I got to go back to what you said in the second quarter, and I haven't seen it since. In the second quarter, on their touchdown drive, they took the line scrimmage and they controlled it with the offensive line. They handed the ball off and they pounded their way down the field. And since then, they've been trying to play catch up with the pass outside down the field. And it's not worth it.
I think Ole Miss is inviting them to throw the ball.
Catching to the outside. Morency tries to cut it back upfield and run out of bounds. Where? The 37-yard line. It'll bring up third down and about 6.
I mean, as good as that run play was right there, I mean, they're still in a third and long situation. And Ole Miss is stacking them up. They're blitzing. They're stacking guys into the inside interior of the line. And they're challenging them to put the ball to the outside and let those Oklahoma State receivers make a play against their secondary.
We'll call it third and 7.
Yeah.
pitch to Tatum Bell, and he has a first down. Excellent call there by Mike Gundy and Les Miles.
Got a little shovel pass, and they got some good blocking downfield.
Well, they tricked him on this one. They spread him out. They showed three wide receivers. Again, it's a passing situation. They go with the shovel pass, and because the defense was spread out, there were holes there for Tatum Bell to run through.
Well, and they invited that pass rush, which is, they've been pretty good at the last few series. That pass rush has been getting upfield. They got upfield, and then the shovel came underneath.
A big third down conversion here for OSU. They were facing second and 21, and now Fields with protection. Looking down the field to Rashad, who's been overthrowing.
Oh, man. It was there, too. It was there. That was the old post corner on the outside.
You know what, though? I don't like this into where it is, because you're going to see Woods has to look back into the sunshine, and I don't think he could adjust to that ball. I don't think he could see it. Watch where he breaks. There's the post. Now the corner, and when he gets out there where the ball, he's got to make an adjustment to it. The sun is right there.
Sounds good by theory. Your guy?
Is that Jesse?
It's your guy.
Oh, yeah. I said, if you're going to put a name on the no-name defense, it's Jesse Mitchell. The heart and soul. There
number
he is.
95. Watch him shoot right in here in between the guard and the center. Beautiful. And what happens is that Noble, 53, can never get position on him, because the one thing that he has, Jesse Mitchell at 6'1", 270, is quickness. When you get into that gap and get upfield,
the other thing he has is he'll be going to law school.
He's smart.
That's right. I had to get that. You got to love a nose guard that's going to go to law school.
Third and 13. Oh. And Woods, a reception down to the 35. They'll move the chains.
And that's it. And a nicely thrown ball by Josh Fields.
At some point in time, this matchup here, who he's been going all day, Travis Johnson, covering Rashawn Woods all day. And at some point in the game, it's going to wear down on him. He played off. He gave him that. And you know what? He's going to choose to play off sometime. This guy's been running all over the field with Rashawn Woods.
I think he's done a good job. But as you saw there, Woods is a guy who doesn't need to get that much separation to make a play.
Look at it again over here. Look how far off he is.
That's what I said. I think they're fighting those attacks.
Bell dropped behind the line of scrimmage by Travis Blanchard.
And Billy, this is
it was
this
there. If you're inviting them to pass, they certainly should have checked to it there. There was nobody in the middle of the field.
That's right. And look at the center.
Look, nobody's
of the field.
Here, and you have one-on-one on the outside over this way.
And look
with
at
your
all,
number one receiver.
Look at all the red jerseys in there to stop the run.
That's something they should have checked out of.
Yep. And Blanchard, again, that whip safety, he's the extra guy. I think they had nine guys in the box that time to stop the run. And if a defense is going to do that, if they're going to put Blanchard in there and the other safety in there, then you've got to go to the pass.
Bell, good overfield tackle at the 38-yard line made by LP Spence. So another third and long coming up for Oklahoma State. The Cowboys converted a moment ago on the long pass to Woods. We'll see here.
Travis Johnson, I'm telling you, just from the where he has to run, from across the field to try to match up everywhere he's going. Right now he's over on the sidelines talking to the coach. He's on the sidelines, and he's been running. This guy's run like a marathon today. He's been all over the field trying to match up with Rashawn Woods. Rashawn Woods is in the huddle. Now, see where he's at? He's all the way across the field now. They're not going to match up with it. They're going to let it play. And Von Hutchins, the man who has caused them problems all year, is out there.
And look how much space he's giving.
Tipped.
Again, we call the name of Travis Johnson.
They blitzed him. They brought the pressure with him that time. That's why he didn't match up. Travis Johnson's going to come right here. And he's going to chuck that block on the outside and jump and get his hands up.
Say, well, how many times have you seen a cornerback coming on a blitz actually put a pass rush move on someone? right? Seriously.
Good point. Usually they go down with a block.
I mean, a lot of linebackers don't use a pass rush. When he put a little quick swim on him and then knock that pass down.
And now he's got to go line up back outside because they're... on a gunner outside. They got two gunners to a side on this punt formation.
Fake punt territory, Billy? No.
Nice.
Switch punt. Down by Fulton. That's a beauty. They'll down it at the 3-yard line. Nicely done. Well, you talk about an arms race. How about this Manning family? Archie, a star at Ole Miss in the late 60s to 1970. Peyton threw for better than 11,000 yards at Tennessee. And now Eli Manning, who has eclipsed the 10,000-yard passing mark here today.
Eli, get me a sandwich.
Now, that was a big-time show.
You better believe it.
Big-time throw.
Wow.
And it actually all ties in. You did that whole thing and all in the family and the Edith thing, because talking to him, he said, we know about your dad, we know about your brother, what about your mom? And he said, without a doubt, she's the one that holds his whole family together.
Olivia Manning.
Yeah, and they said, he said, Eli said, all of us couldn't do anything without her.
And he also said when he's trying to get an extended curfew and his dad answers the phone, he says, could you put mom on?
When Olivia, was growing former up. Homecoming queen at Ole Miss, back when she was dating Archie Manning. Throwing a little bit behind the intended receiver. So to bring up second down and 10. There you get a look at Olivia Manning, and sitting next to her husband, Archie Manning. Their oldest son, Cooper, came to play wide receiver at Ole Miss, but was diagnosed with a spinal problem. It was too much of a risk to get back on the football field. And he has become very, very close with Eli. Growing up and watching him play in high school and now college. Collins again down on the second time that's happened today.
Yeah, you saw the reaction by Eli, too. He took it on himself. You know, he just went, threw his arms down, hit his thigh pads. Yep, he told him. He said, my fault. And you know what? You want that in a quarterback, you know? Guys just see that.
Yeah, absolutely. You don't want a guy that's pointing fingers this way, that way.
Right.
You want him to take it upon himself.
It's a big play for Oklahoma State. Third and 13. They're down by 10.
I think this is where Eli Manning's strength really comes. Third and long situations. He's made a lot of big plays this season for Ole Miss.
Barely got the playoff. And Manning down the middle, checked off to the line of scrimmage, and delivers a strike to Kerry Johnson.
That's what he does. You know, if you watched Ole Miss go down to Auburn and beat Auburn this year in Auburn, Eli Manning was in these third and long situations over and over again, and over and over again he converted.
Timmy, watch this. This is Eli Manning messing with the defense. And watch this. Vernon Grant's going to drop all the way back into coverage after he's up in front, but he never gets to where he's supposed to be. They're supposed to have high-low coverage right there on the seam, and he never gets there because they've been playing that game trying to confuse Manning.
Here he is again. Across the 45 to the 46-yard line to bring up second down and less than 5.
And I thought it was interesting talking with Eli that he really wasn't going to go to Ole Miss. He was pretty much set on going to either Virginia or Texas. And Coach David Cutcliffe was at Tennessee, was recruiting him to Tennessee.
And he didn't want to go there.
Didn't want to follow Peyton. But then when Cutcliffe went to Mississippi, he said, you know what, that's a good place. And he said, well, what about your following your dad's footsteps? He said, that was so long ago that, you know, it's not like the student body knew my dad.
Again, it's Pearson, and he sticks his nose ahead to get a first down, and Bashan fired up about it. Sophomore out of Ripley, Mississippi.
You know who's been doing a good job is who's ever been at left tackle. Trey Stallings, number 70. He was in there. He's done an outstanding job. Here's Harris here. He blocks down. And then watch the fullback come back and cut the backside end. Right here. He cuts him. And they've really been giving Greg Richmond a tough time today because he's their speed guy, he's their sack guy, and they've been doing different things to chip him and keep him away from Eli Manning.
Woo! Met Pearson head on a couple of yards behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of two. And that will be the final play of the third quarter. 24-14, Ole Miss leads. We're back to Dallas after these messages from your local Fox station.
You are watching Fox Sports.
The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox, brought to you by SBC. Going beyond the call. By Nissan, who invites you to shift the way you move through the world. By Singular, the wireless company that fits you best. And by Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
And you know, it's hard to be fit as a fiddle when you're built like a tuba.
Hey!
You can apply that to some of the guys we talked about today. In front of both their offensive lines. Big tubas out there.
I never knew you were so glib. I haven't seen that side of you.
It's a fun time, man. It's my New Year's resolution.
I like it.
Second and 12 for Manning and the Rebels. They're chasing, and he unloads down the field, just throwing it away.
This is really more of what they wanted to do. They wanted to be able to put pressure on Eli Manning, and the guy they thought was going to get the most of it is right there, Greg Richmond. He's got 12 sacks on the season. He's an outside pass rusher, and you talk about turning a program around it and being a guy, you know, from Oklahoma City, about 45 minutes right away from Stillwater, who could have gone to Oklahoma, but ended up following his coach and being part of that senior class that's been a part of the Oklahoma State turnaround.
Third down. And delivers a beautiful strike to Espy. Another Ole Miss first down.
And there was no time for pass rush then. No time at all. There was good coverage. And that's not a college throw, Tim.
Right. I was thinking the same thing. I was thinking, folks, if you want to see why Eli Manning is going to be not only a good, but a franchise quarterback in the NFL, there it is right there. That pass with that accuracy.
Never broke stride. And he had Darren Williams right in his hip, you know. Never broke stride, and the ball was right on the money.
Pearson picks up a couple of yards. Well, a couple of big third down conversions on this drive to keep the ball away from Oklahoma State. He had a third and 12, went for 26. A third and 11, went for 22.
You know, Tim, you were mentioning that Greg Richmond Sr. and he helped Les Miles turn the program around and come in there. And the guy, he came from Oklahoma City with a bunch of his friends.
Yeah. He said there was a bunch of guys, friends and rivals. Albert Craig was one
Rashawn
of them.
Woods.
Rashawn Woods was a rival. Said they play each other in the big rivalry, the Soul Bowl, they called it. He said once Rashawn Woods went, a lot of other Oklahoma City players said, hey, maybe the place to go.
Gary Johnson inside the 10.
And OSU needs to come up with something big right now. They've got to change momentum somehow, some way, if they want to keep this thing within reach.
I think they need a turnover, Bill. They went with a three-man rush, so there were plenty of defenders out in the field.
Well, you go to that three-man rush and that zone concept, yeah, when you're trying to look for a pick.
Right. I think now is the time when you want to put a lot of pressure. You want to put stunts. You want to come with everybody and get some blitzes going, whether it's run or pass.
Pearson lunges. Did he get in? No. He's about a half a yard short, if not less than that.
Boy, boy.
Well, they tried the blitz. Vernon Grant
was in there.
Yeah, he's coming right.
He's gonna come right downhill right, right here.
And
he takes out the lead blocker.
Yeah.
And gets underneath.
Just a very strong run by Pearson.
Second and goal from the one.
And that's what he's improved at over his time here at Mississippi, becoming a stronger runner.
Manning carries it in for the touchdown.
That's almost disrespectful to be down there on the one and to just run a quarterback sneak, right? I mean, that's just saying we own the interior of the line of scrimmage. Not up, not over, just get out of the way.
Point after by Nichols. And it is good. This game was tied at 14. 17 unanswered points by Eli Manning and the Rebels. 12:30 to go in Dallas. Ole Miss in front. They've waited 41 years to play in the Cotton Bowl. And this has been a very impressive performance by the Rebels. David Cutcliffe, the 2003 SEC Coach of the Year. They shared the first ever SEC Western Division title with LSU. LSU beat them head-to-head in a great game in Oxford. Short kick. And Jones brings it out to the 28-yard line. Eli Manning trying to finish off his fabulous career at Ole Miss with a win. Ole Miss leading 31-14. Still a long way to go. Les Miles' team trying to play catch-up. Miles, an alum of the University of Michigan, where he was an assistant coach. On a couple of different occasions, he knows all about winning, and when, of course, you play at Michigan, you learn a great deal about winning, and he's trying to really revive this Oklahoma State program. Not that it was left for dead, because Bobby Simmons did a pretty good job before him, but Les has lofty goals for this program now.
Pat Jones and Jimmy Johnson.
The thing that impresses me is that he's been able to actually go into Texas and take players out of Texas.
How about who he just signed? He went into the heart of Houston, deep in Texas, and signed a young man, Robert Reed.
Play fake, Fields with time to throw, and lots of it, and has Woods open, and he caught it.
Oh! Now that was pass interference.
Yeah, and it's going to be, of course, declined.
And this is the strength of Rashawn Woods, and we've seen him make some catches like this all day long.
Using his body like you talked about.
Yeah, and catching a ball that drops in on it and using his body. Here it is. Here's his body. He positions. It drops in.
Pass interference. Defense. Penalty is declined. Play result.
Seven catches now, well over 100 receiving yards, 136 for Rashawn Woods.
How about the little move? Do you see that little wiggle he put on Travis Johnson?
Yeah, Travis Johnson actually grabbed hold of him. Like I said, Billy, if you're going to man him up, you've got to put the ball in his hands.
I agree with you 100%. With Travis Johnson, the job he's done today has been outstanding. But I don't think you can expect it all day.
Lawrence down to the 20-yard line. You know, Les Miles, obviously, when you're recruiting in Texas and Oklahoma, you're recruiting against those schools I just mentioned. You're also recruiting against the likes of Kansas State and Nebraska and the heartland of this Big 12 conference, if you will.
But I think two huge things for this program. They beat Oklahoma two out of the last 3 years, and then this year they beat K-State,
right?
So if you win those kinds of big games against your close rivals, then you can recruit against them.
Because as you know, Tim, that's one of the first things recruiters talk about when they come into your house, they visit with you and your parents, and they ask you what other schools have been talking to you, what other schools, and they'll be the first to tell you that if they beat them or not. Yeah. You know, they'll bring that right up. Well, of course, you probably saw our game, son, didn't you, where we beat Kansas State. And they bring that right to the forefront.
As they should.
And it's all a selling job. And Les Miller and the University of Oklahoma State has done an outstanding job of selling what they've got. Les Miles, I'm sorry.
Third down and three. And denied the first down. Well, Les Miles going to have to make a decision now whether to go on fourth. You would assume he would, down 17. We talked to Les Miles about his program and the state it's in.
We are aspiring to championships, and we are aspiring to compete with the very finest in the country. And with success comes expectation, and expectation is a good thing.
He's right.
Well, he's expecting to try and get back in it right now. He's going to go fourth and three.
This is where they want to put Fields on the move to roll him out of that pocket.
Outside, one-on-one. Man, no help deep. Oh, no!
They go that way. What a catch. Wow. What a catch.
Oh, my.
As advertised here today, Rashawn Woods.
There it was. There was a one-on-one. With no help deep.
Man, and he still catches it. I mean, Travis Johnson is all over him. All over him, and he still catches the ball. That's a gift. Right? I mean, to be able to have that kind of concentration in that nanosecond and see it and keep focused on it and pull it down.
Woods, 8 receptions, 155 yards. Morency pushed to the outside. And it looked like he lost a yard.
To me, Oklahoma's best success in the run has still come. Oklahoma State's best success in the run has still come when they've gone downhill.
Yes. Yeah, especially down here against this defense. I think you do want to go right at them.
With the strength of Morency and the size of the offensive line, you don't want to go outside and play into the hands of the speed of Mississippi's defense.
Second and goal. Morency leads in favor of Tatum Bell. And he gets a pitch. Scramble for the ball. And at the 1 yard line, it rolls out of bounds. So they gain yardage.
Than it is the National Football League. And it looks like it is.
Well, it looked like that Bell actually had possession of the ball before he went out of bounds. I think that's what ultimately they're going to make the call. I think they said that Bell, after talking it over, they had four officials down there. And that's where Bell ran out of bounds about the...
Either way, it's passing to Rashawn Woods that's got them down here.
Trying to lean in the fullback Sean Willis, and he's denied. Fourth and goal coming up.
It looked from here as if he had that push, as if he extended the ball and it broke the plane. Obviously, the head linesman and linesman have a better view of that line of scrimmage down there on the goal line.
Well, now the old Miss Faithful will rise as one, trying to pretty much slam the door on this one if Oklahoma State can't get in.
You go back to the big Mississippi win against Auburn. They shut Auburn down late in the game right down here.
Touchdown.
to Vernon Lorenzi.
Nice leap, wasn't it? And a nice play. I like the counter, right? They came back, and there was actually a pretty good hole there.
I'd love to see that. Now, if I'm playing defense, I didn't like to see it over top of me. But I certainly like to see our offense find a way. If it's not there, we're going to find a way to get it there. And that's exactly what Marnsey does.
I'll tell you, the guy who had the key block was Badgett, the tight end.
Phillips for the point after, and that will bring the Cowboys within 10, and still a long way to go in this one. 8:49 to play. Morency in for the touchdown. One 8:50 to play here at the 2004 SBC Cotton Bowl in Dallas, Texas. A beautiful afternoon. Temperatures in the 70s.
Couldn't be a better day.
No. 10 plays, 72 yards on that drive for the Cowboys to get into the end zone and get back in the game. So now they need a defensive stop, something they've been unable to do by and large against Eli and company throughout the day. 31-21, Ole Miss with a ball. Let's go downstairs to Brian Baldinger.
All right, John, thanks. I'm down here, I'm joined by the proud parents of Rashawn and Dewan Woods. That's Larry Woods and Juana Woods. And you have another son here, Donovan, who's a redshirt freshman quarterback. This has got to be an incredibly proud day and moment for both of you.
Yes, it is. I mean, it's something you just can't imagine.
And we always hoped that they would go on to college and be successful, but this is exceeding even our expectations by a tremendous amount. And it's wonderful to have the family here and to be a part of such a festive occasion.
Larry, I look behind us and we got the banner here, SBC. You've been a 30-year employee of SBC. You have a daughter, Rosalind, as well, that works for SBC. I mean, it all kind of ties together. It's a great week for you.
Oh, yeah. SBC has been real good to me. They've allowed me to be able to take care of my family because it's, after all, it's six kids, and it takes after-tax dollars to send those kids to college. So the scholarships are wonderful.
Larry, you're a basketball player. What's it like to have three kids playing Division I college football?
As I said, it exceeds our expectations. We were just hopeful that they would go on to college, but to have them playing at a Division I university like Oklahoma State is just fascinating.
Juana, it's 31-21, fourth quarter. You've seen these things. I mean, how are you holding up right now, and should they get the ball to Rashawn and Dewan just a little bit more?
Of course.
All right, Tom, the Woods. Juana, Larry, enjoy the rest of the game. Thanks for joining us. Tom, back up to you.
Boy, I love the way Mom said that.
Well, you know Mom wants that ball getting there. You know that.
Great stuff. Yeah, a lot of talk about Donovan being in line to try and replace Josh Fields. If, again, for those of you that weren't with us earlier, Josh Fields, a highly thought of, highly watched third baseman for the great Oklahoma State baseball program, may get a chance to sign professionally if he is drafted highly enough. And then all the speculation about who takes over at quarterback if Fields leaves. There you see Donovan Woods, a red shirt. They have Al Pena, the transfer from Georgia Tech. And Robbie Reed, arguably the greatest recruit ever signed in the history of Oklahoma State football as far as billing goes coming out of high school.
And I think that speaks volumes for the program, for Les Miles and what he's accomplished. When you can go down and get a Robbie Reed right there, number 14, who graduated just in December, is now able to be on the sidelines and wear at Oklahoma State University.
Enrolled in school.
Exactly. That's a program on the rise. And actually, that's what the Cotton Bowl is.
Well, they need their defense right now to stop this third down conversion if the program is going to continue to rise and win this Cotton Bowl.
They come after Manning, and he had to get rid of it. So they come up with a stop, and they'll get it back with 6:30 to go.
Well done. Greg Richmond from the outside and Duren blitzing from the linebacker position.
And they had man coverage, and they had to blitz him. They're having to blitz to fabricate some kind of pressure. Here comes underneath it, one to the left, one to the right. Man coverage downfield. It looked like there was a breakdown in the read there with the receivers.
Well, their defense needed to stop Ole Miss. Ole Miss kind of had it going. They had the rhythm. They were running. They were throwing. And that was a huge conversion right there. And now it's time for Mrs. Woods to get her wish.
That one will roll out of bounds at the 22-yard line, so a long way to go. And Oklahoma State, plenty of firepower to make up this 10-point deficit. We'll be back. We brought it up earlier, Timmy, about the sights and the sounds of college football. Great advice.
Oh, man.
Great advice. 73,928.
Beautiful day. Two schools that have really gotten themselves back onto the national scene. This game is huge for both of these programs to be here at the Cotton Bowl.
And each with a chance to get a 10-win season.
Well, think of the teams that have been here in the past and how great they all are right now.
Fields going for a bundle and finds his main man.
There you go, Mama. Again, it's that single matchup. And Travis Johnson has done a very nice job, but Billy, you said it so right. You can't expect him to stay all day with a receiver the caliber of Rashawn Woods.
The guy's run a marathon. He runs all over the field wherever he lines up, to the left side, to the right side. He's been running all those deep routes all day long. You have to give him some help over the top. He's been by himself, Tim.
And we only saw him.
And here, he's going to take a breather here. This is when he takes a breather. It's when he plays off that far, is when he takes a little breather.
Not much of that.
I mean, it's a nice play by Johnson, but it's still a 9-yard pickup.
And they're taking advantage of it.
By the way, Keyshawn Johnson from Southern Cal holds a record for most receiving yards in a Cotton Bowl game set in 1995, 222. And Rashawn Woods is banging on the door.
206 right now, 10 catches. And if they're going to single coverage it, cover him, he will break that.
Pitch it to Tillman Bell. And he's down to the 17.
You know, I think, Tim, I really believe that Mississippi must have so much respect for the running game of Oklahoma State that they're going to refuse to double cover Rashawn Woods.
Well, if Oklahoma does not prevail, I really believe Mike Gundy, the coordinator, offensive coordinator, is going to look back and think that maybe he went to Woods too late in here in the second half. Because remember, they tried to stay with the run earlier, and it really did not work.
Boy, Oklahoma State wasted a lot of time getting that play into the sideline. And then an incomplete throw to Rashawn Woods again. Well, we're under 5 minutes right now. They need to pick it up a little bit, down a couple of scores.
What a day he's had thus far, even though they're trailing. It's been the Rashawn Woods show. Whether it's been underneath, whether it's been screens to the outside, whether it's been sensational sideline grabs and acrobatic stunts over the middle, Rashawn Woods has really put on a show here at the Cotton Bowl today and knocking on the door of breaking a longtime record of 226 yards receiving.
Imagine that motion, and Fields a short drop, and again looking for Woods. And again he got it.
Made it look easy.
Oh, man. Von Hutchins went with the press coverage. He rolled the dice. And you know what, Billy? You're right. Ole Miss over-respecting OSU's run game because Hutchins had no help at all.
And believe it or not, with all of the talk we've had about Eli Manning today, Josh Fields has now broken the record for the most yards passing in Cotton Bowl history, 307.
Unbelievable.
He can thank Rashawn Woods, because I'll tell you what, Woods was open downfield and actually had to come back for that pass.
Watch his body position. We talked about, Tim, so much, how he blocks out Von Hutchins with his body like a basketball player would.
Well, Eddie Sutton would be proud. Going up to get the rebound and bring it home. The The SBC Cotton Bowl Classic on Fox, brought to you by SBC, going beyond the call. This has turned into a thriller now. Back-to-back touchdowns after falling behind by 17 has made it a three-point game. We saw a great comeback by Purdue yesterday, only to lose in overtime to Georgia.
We also had back-to-back records broken on that last play.
And again out of the end zone. Yeah, you mentioned it, Billy, on that last touchdown throw from Fields to Woods. Woods breaks the all-time record for receiving yards in Cotton Bowl history. And Fields, most yards passing in Cotton Bowl history.
Beautiful fade pattern to the corner of the end zone. And Woods used his body like he has been doing all day.
Yeah, he, you know, Woods
in
actually
manners.
He actually had Hutchins beat, and then Fields actually underthrew it, and then Woods came back to get it and score. That body control is amazing.
Turner, a big hole and nearly broke it.
You know, I was just going to say, right now, if I'm Ole Miss, I'm going to put the ball in the hands of Tremaine Turner. He's up over 100 yards now today. And we've seen them at times dominate the line of scrimmage. And so I believe David Cutliffe is just going to try to run the clock out now, right behind this big offensive line. Oklahoma State's defense has got to come up with a big play and put the ball back into Fields' hands.
Turner only had one 100-yard rushing game the entire season. And he's right at triple figures here today. His only other 100-yard performance came in the victory over South Carolina when he ran for 117 yards and two touchdowns. We brought up how important a 10-win season is. Been better than 30 years since they've been able to make that claim at Ole Miss. How about Oklahoma State? They did it in 88. And looking down the field, just out of the reach of a diving Mike Espy.
Well, the run game was working, and then they went to the play action fake. It's good coverage on the outside by Robert Jones because he's in man to man. Oklahoma State is stacking up the safeties to stop the run.
Perfectly thrown ball, right area. Right where the receiver was supposed to be. Just great coverage by Robert Jones.
Jones got his hand right on that ball.
Second and 10.
Draw.
Although if Eli's checking it off, he's got to check it to a pass because the box is full.
Third and 10 coming up, and that clock running. By the time they snap it again, will be under 3 minutes, unless Les Miles is thinking about a timeout now, which he will call.
I'll tell you, the chess game right now isn't really chess. It's checkers, right? I mean, they're manning up the wide receivers on the outside, and they're putting the rest of the nine defenders right in there to stop Ole Miss from running the ball.
First timeout used in the second half by Oklahoma State. They have two left.
Here, king me.
Well, you know what?
Because I want to jump over all your guys.
Yeah, don't forget this. The king is Eli Manning when it comes to third and long, right? We saw him do it against Auburn. That's how they beat Auburn down there. And we've seen him do it numerous times today.
Now, let's remember the last third and long they have, Oklahoma State blitzed, had man coverage, and won.
Duren, right? Duren came clean. I think they've got to go with a blitz. If they let Eli Manning sit back there and have time, he probably will find his receiver.
I think you have to fabricate some kind of pressure.
Yep.
I really do, because when a quarterback like Eli, if you drop back in his zone, he'll beat you.
Here they come.
Here they come. It's picked up. And
he's got the arm behind him.
Absolutely.
He had the hook going. It was a great break on the ball, and he got his arm extended in front, but his back arm had the hook around the waist.
Look, he pushed right through him, too, I think, Billy.
Watch him turn around here.
Interference, defense, spot foul.
See the hook? See that arm around the waist?
Yeah. I think he put his shoulder right in his back. You know, that was excellent pass protection by Ole Miss, because they came with the blitzers, both of them, both linebackers from the outside, the defensive line up the middle, and Manning had time.
And now the clock is really going to become a factor here.
OSU with two timeouts remaining. They'll keep it on the ground. The turner, he tries to break it to the outside, cut back inside, bottled up there, and Oklahoma State has to use a timeout now. 3:01 to play, and now they have one timeout remaining. It took Ole Miss a little while to get going, but then it got going in a hurry. Tremaine Turner with a touchdown catch, likewise for Espy. And then Turner on the ground, and then to open up that 17-point lead, a touchdown and a field goal. But Oklahoma State has come back to score 14 unanswered points.
Well, we thought we'd see some offense today, right, from two very high-scoring offenses, and they have not disappointed us, have they?
No. No, not at all.
I think the most surprising thing to me today, though, from a football standpoint, is Ole Miss's ability to really contain the running game of Oklahoma State.
I'm not so sure if they didn't get out of it early and make Josh Fields say, you know what, Josh Fields, you beat us.
No, I think they contained it, Billy. I mean, Oklahoma State has 110 yards on the ground at 37 carries. Only about 3 yards a carry. That's an offense with three runners that average over 6 yards a carry. Twice what they've averaged today.
And on the other side of it, Oklahoma State didn't do that.
Handed off to Pearson, who's checked in for Turner, and he crosses midfield. Another third down upcoming. The clock under three. Let's check in with Brian Baldinger.
Hey, Tom, Bill. Timmy, I tell you, I've been down here this entire fourth quarter. There has been nobody that has sat down. And the way the tickets have been distributed for this game, they cut this stadium right in half. And the orange and the red are right up next to each other. The theater in the stadium right now can't get any better than this as we come down to the finish.
Well, you're right, Baldy. I mean, we're lucky to be all the way at the top.
Well, what happens if you're here and you want a Coke? Can you get one from this aisle, or do you always have to go to that side to get your own Coke?
That would probably be answered by where you scored on your IQ test. Vernon Grant, the sophomore out of Duncanville, Texas, is down for OSU. Got to look a moment ago at the Field Scoble Trophy. Those schools playing for that and would proudly bring it back on home at the end of this one.
I say whoever doesn't go home with that trophy with today's game has nothing to be ashamed of.
Yep.
They came to a major bowl, both schools, both programs rebuilding, rebounding. This is their first major bowl in several years, and I don't think either one of them has anything to be ashamed of. It's been a really great football game.
And, you know, both of these teams have practiced like this was a very important game. You know, sometimes maybe if you're a team that's ranked in the top five at the beginning of the year, you're not in a BCS bowl. Maybe you show up here this week and not put in the work like you should. For these teams, it has been work, work, and work.
And I think Billy raised a good point earlier where you said, you know, this bowl has been kind of a springboard for other teams like LSU, like Oklahoma.
And K-State. You know, teams that were here before, Arkansas, you know, teams that have been here, and the programs are really, this is a place where you can showcase your program and just tell the nation, hey, here we are.
We're big time.
And we are big time. And this is the first step into big time.
Third down. They hand it off to Turner. Swings his way, breaks a tackle. The 25. You're wondering about the Manning family in bowl games. Archie Manning went 2-1. Peyton Manning went 3-1. Eli trying to cap it off going 2-0. Pretty good run.
I've always said a quarterback's best friend is a good run game and a good runner. And Tremaine Turner has been that best friend today for this game.
133 yards on 20 carries for Turner. He'll get another. Nope, he came out of the game after that 25-yard run. It'll be Pearson.
You know, when I see Oklahoma State, I see a team that reminds me of the Kansas City Chiefs. Just in the aspect that, I mean, he's got that prolific offense that can put up all the points. And if your defense can find a way to just tighten down that run just a bit, you know, contain the run, Tim, like you were explaining how Mississippi controlled the run of Oklahoma State. If they can find a way to tighten that down up front, and they've got some young guys that have come in as freshmen that they believe are going to take care of that.
Pearson again. He's to the 17.
36 run plays for Ole Miss. And close to 200 yards.
No, that's what we're talking about. And, you know, you need to tighten down the bolts on that a little bit.
Well, Ole Miss had a dramatic improvement from last year to this year in the running department, improving over 49 rushing yards per game last year to this year. And that's something that David Cutcliffe wants to do more of, run the ball.
And that hasn't been one individual. That's been a three-headed monster, too. It's been all by committee. Jacobs, Pearson, Turner.
Third down and two. Pearson bottled up and denied, it looks like, a first down. But Oklahoma State out of timeouts. And I would imagine Ole Miss, there is no way that Ole Miss is going to.
You don't want to try to kick a field goal. You just want to. Just want to go with that. Probably.
Collins came out to the sideline.
Well, now they're setting the play clock. This one's over.
Boy, they reset that clock very late. Not that it would have made a huge difference.
They did.
The celebration is on in the state of Mississippi. And why not? First time in 41 years Ole Miss has played in the Cotton Bowl. And they will go home victorious. 31-28.
Just like Tim talked about, there's nobody that should leave this place feeling bad about what they showed out here today.
Two strong teams, two strong performances.
It's now seven consecutive winning seasons for the Ole Miss Rebels. That's something the program has not done since the mid-60s, the early 70s. And David Cutcliffe has brought a plan from Tennessee.
They've been winning
football games in Tennessee for a long time.
I tell you what, David Cutcliffe's got to feel good about. He's going to lose Eli Manning to the National Football League. But the way his team ran the football today, that's going to be a great foundation for another young quarterback to step into this program and have an excellent opportunity to showcase his skills.
Final collegiate game for Eli Manning. And he goes out a winner. 31-28 our final, back with a trophy presentation in a moment. Ole Miss a winner in Eli Manning's final collegiate game here at the 2004 SBC Cotton Bowl. For the trophy presentation, let's go downstairs to Brian Boldingham.
Well, the 68th SBC Cotton Bowl was finished. It was a thrilling game. And now to start the presentations of this Field Scoville Trophy, I hand it over to the president of SBC Southwest, Bill Blaze. Bill.
Coach Cutcliffe, if you're a fan of football, it doesn't get any better than this. Congratulations on an outstanding game and a fantastic season. I'd like to turn it over to my friend, Finn Ewan, president of the Cotton Bowl Committee. And I want to thank you, Finn, for an outstanding job of leadership the last 2 years.
Thank you very much, Bill.
Coach Cutcliffe, you're one of the nicest guys in college football. And I want to present to you the Phil Scoville Trophy. You guys are the champions of the SBC Cotton Bowl Classic.
Outstanding. First, let me say how much we appreciate the hospitality of the SBC people, the Cotton Bowl family. You're outstanding. And I'm going to tell you what, I'm so proud of a bunch of Ole Miss Rebels right here that got the job done. Win 10!
Coach Cutcliffe, this is your 40th win here as a head coach. Probably none bigger here than the Cotton Bowl. It's been 41 years since the Rebels were able to take this trophy home.
That's as sweet as it gets right here. I'm really proud of these seniors. I wish everybody in the stands would give our Ole Miss seniors a big hand. Outstanding.
MVP today is Eli Manning. You had that nice task of coaching Peyton for 4 years at Tennessee, 5 years here at Ole Miss. What's he been immensely meant to this program?
Well, Eli's a tremendous competitor, a great person, a great player, a very unselfish player. Really proud for him and happy that he was able to win the award.
Coach, it's been a heck of a 5 years here. I mean, what does the winning the Cotton Bowl here do for this program?
This raises the bar. We're not through. We got a lot of work left to do. We got a lot of places to go.
Thank you very much, Coach Cutcliffe. Enjoy the win. Tommy, back up to you.
All right, Brian, thank you very much. Congratulations indeed to both teams, Ole Miss and Oklahoma State. And we echo the sentiments of David Cutcliffe talking about the hospitality here in Dallas. Fabulous, as always. For more information on today's game, log on to FoxSports.com. Join Fox Sports Sunday, the NFC wildcard game, Seattle and Green Bay. Coverage begins with a pregame show, noon Eastern, 9 Pacific. For Tim Green, Bill Moss, Brian Baldinger, our entire crew, Tom Brenneman saying so long from Dallas. 31-28, Ole Miss wins it. This has been a presentation of Fox Sports. Happy New Year.